time for a bath, time for bath, time for a bath, and time for bath. Time for a bath, time for bath, time for a bath, and time for bath.
I wish my refund hurry up so I can have a taxitude.
Time for a bath, time for bath, time for a bath, and time for bath.
I'ma be like, let me get 20 on pump 3.
Time for a bath, time for bath, time for a bath, and time for bath.
Matter of fact, make it 25, and yes, I would like to donate to the March of Dimes, so ring me up that Coke and candy bar, 2 for $2.22 deal, where $1 goes to March 2. Oh, and ring these Skittles up for my kid, too. And when the cashier tells me to have a nice day, I'm gonna be like, no, ma'am, you have a blessed day, sugar.
Time for a bath, time for bath, time for a bath, and time for bath.
Pull down my shades like Kim Kardashian, smile like Gabrielle Union.
Time for a bath, time for bath, time for a bath, and time for bath.
Flip my bundles like Nicki Minaj, and queen out the door like Beyonce.
Time for a bath, time for bath, time for a bath, and time for bath.
Goofy face, goofy face, goofy face, heart, 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 muscle, muscle, muscle.
Time for a bath, time for bath, time for a bath, and time for bath.
Sassy black girl, sassy black girl, sassy black girl, kiss, kiss, kiss. Hashtag so what, hashtag I ain't shame, hashtag my money, hashtag call me taxitude, honey.
Live from the Injured on the Go Just Call Mo studio.
It's a blast!
It's Orlando's own Tom and Dan.
Hello, this is your Mediocre Time with Tom and Dan program. We hope that you will find our presentation precise, joke-heavy, and just right. Thanks.
Welcome to the Friday free show of A Mediocre Time.
And that, my friends, is how you start it. You start it with the vague off-air, you know, sort of deal. Like you're gonna say something you shouldn't say.
Yeah.
That's the way you do it. Hey, it is another A Mediocre Time with Tom and Dan. I'm Dan.
I'm Tom. Samantha Haar's here.
Hey.
There we go.
How you doing, Sam?
I'm doing good. How you guys doing?
Good.
Great. Wonderful.
So
just catching up with talk.
Yeah,
to,
you're telling me the secrets.
Just
I gotta wait for the break.
Catching up for my latest episode of Talk to a podcast.
Are you subscribed?
Yeah, I like and subscribe.
It's easy to hate on it, but I want to.
I find her very likable.
It is fascinating to hear.
She's the Jelly Roll of podcasting.
The point of view.
I would say the bad baby.
Never been
She's
a better time to be normal and be successful.
Yeah, I'm serious. It's true.
I'm serious when I say this. Mm-hmm. Never been a better time to be. Like, I used to think
we're turning on Hollywood. That's what's happening.
I used to think that being 5'2 and covered in tattoos would, like, set me apart, right?
Mm.
But it doesn't now. Like, now being normal sets you apart. No.
Yeah.
Like being a normal side,
yeah,
like you are more unique in the new world than a little person like me is.
Yeah, I don't see a lot of little people with tattoos running around here. So you are kind
okay,
of unique.
All right, I guess I am.
I look around, though. I see a lot of me.
You're looking for?
I have a unique look. I do
I'm like,
a
that's a
look.
Me, that's a me, this yeah. guy's
that's
a me.
That's a me.
He's in studio.
It's like, a me, I'm audio.
A bunch of average white dudes.
Yeah, it is a bunch of average white dudes.
Wait a minute.
You guys are the rarity. Like, you know, Sam,
Why am I the rarity?
Well, just tall, blonde, you know, that's just an odd combination.
It's
not normal.
Tall and blonde is an odd combination. Oh,
I think medium-sized brown hair is the standard,
I guess,
right?
Like, your number one across the globe would be tall and brown, right? Medium brown?
No.
Medium brown.
It's small brown.
Small brown?
Yeah,
small
brown. I think.
The number one body shape in the world is small brown.
Yes.
I'm going to disagree with you. I'm going to say medium brown.
I think Indian.
Because I think Indian people are larger. I think you're skewing it Asian heavy. And even though they're over there,
I'm going medium rare.
I feel like we need to back out of this conversation.
You've been gone for a while.
I was about to go deeper.
Oh, yeah. I was getting my shovel.
I was about to, you know what they do in India? Oh, I'll tell you. Sorry. Anyway. Sam,
yes.
How's it been going?
Good. What's going on with you guys?
I follow you on Instagram
media. Are you looking for the photos?
Yeah, because no. The last show you did, you didn't say that you might do an OnlyFans.
No, come on.
She said that. I didn't just make that up.
I'm following.
She said that.
To see my friend have all the fun that I'm not having.
I thought you said no one has joy.
He does say that a lot.
Well,
he doesn't think understand. I'm faking it.
You know
you
what
think
he said?
I'm
stuck in my bubble.
Yeah.
My joyless bubble.
Have you gotten out of it?
He's trying.
No. But I poke my head out every once in a while. Yeah. I'm like, what the hell's going
on
here?
He does like those astronauts did when they did the spacewalk, where they just pop their head out of the capsule and they're like, that's enough.
Good enough.
That's good.
And then so I see, it in your posts, and like you are.
She has a lot of joy.
You're watching let's say you're watching the Bucks game with your husband.
They dress up.
You're both are wearing.
They dress up.
Matching jerseys.
Yeah, my dog
that.
Even has a jersey.
And
yeah, my dog has that. Wait, my dog does not. I want that jersey, the normal
Chewy.
Jersey. My dog
not sponsored.
I bought a Atlanta Falcons for Dansby, and it's cool. But they sent him the Zubaz.
Oh.
His is like a old school 1980s retro, and I want the standard.
Yeah, but the dogs look better in Zubaz.
Okay. All right, that's the funniest thing you said since you've left, by the way.
Okay.
That's the most fun thing he said.
Has he gotten worse with the grumpy?
Oh, well, we hit a peak last week. We had a peak.
Grumpy athlete now?
He is a grumpy athlete
now. No. Not an athlete.
You know what he reminds me of now?
It's Tom Brady.
He reminds me of an astronaut.
Loves work.
Grumpy astronaut.
Won't stop working.
Yeah, I didn't realize how much work sucks. And then I was like, if
Tom
I do
DeLong
this.
Tom told us a long time. Yeah.
I'll end up liking it. That's why all these other people, they must love it.
Oh, fake it till you make it.
Yeah.
That's what everybody's doing.
Yeah, yeah. I'm like, there's got to be a reason why all these other people are doing it.
Oh, every business owner that I see, I know the jig's up. I know you don't know shit.
Most business owners aren't doing a lot of the work.
Every business owner I've met recently, you don't know shit.
Yeah, yeah.
All of you.
Yeah. We own the wrong business.
Yeah.
Like, you got to own.
You guys run everything, too.
Yeah.
Now that I'm gone.
Oh, God, you have no idea.
What's going on?
Oh, we're long hours.
I forgot
hours
to
now.
Tell you how worse it got since you left.
Long hours now. Did you? Okay, so when you left, and then we put in the bodega because we thought.
You emailed these.
I don't know what the hell's going on in this corner.
Oh, it's all wrong. Rotten now.
Don't look at it. All of the
expired chips.
That was my big idea. Once you left, I was bodega time.
I went to use the bathroom when I got here. No toilet paper.
We have.
It's gray, though. We have gray toilet paper. Have you seen our gray toilet paper?
Yeah, it was falling apart in my hands.
No, it's gray. It's from IKEA. Andrea got it for us.
Is it recycled paper?
No, it's just fashion. It's fashion. Hold on.
Paper.
I'll go get it.
Did you realize, Sam, that when you email people for Weird Job Wednesday, they never email you back?
Oh, yeah. For sure.
What? Do you tell us?
And then you text them and they're like, I'll be ready in 5 minutes. And then you call them and they don't pick up. Then you never hear from them again. Oh, wow. Look at this.
Yeah, it's fashion.
Is this for spooky season?
Well, I brought it in last week, but Tom was so grumpy that when I said Andrea got it for him, he's like, get this fucking shit off my fucking desk.
It does look like quality paper.
That's kind of how you were like, what the fuck is this shit?
No.
Fuck your cunt of a wife and fuck her fucking toilet paper, you little midget dick.
You're doing what my wife. You were like, hey, I got this great toilet paper. I was like, cool.
No, you didn't give me
I was like, all right.
He didn't give me an all right.
You gotta click your heels.
He didn't give me an all right. He was like, what the fuck? Fuck that.
No.
And fuck you.
He's that grumpy?
I'll fucking kill you, motherfucker.
No. That's how they take
you. You pussy ass motherfucker. Fucking do
that's
something.
That's how he received.
Yeah.
Then he held me down.
Sitting in the car looking forward. And Chris is like, what's wrong with you?
Then
why
he held
are you so
me down.
Mad all the time?
Exuding
he's like,
grumpiness.
Fucking do something. Do something. He did some of those.
And then everybody's like, well, maybe it's my fault. And I'm like, no. It's got to be me.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Yeah, I don't know why they make that toilet paper either. It's very odd. Doesn't look like it would work well. So
back to having fun, Sam.
Yeah.
So you're watching the Bucks game. You're with your husband. You're dressed.
Well, this last game wasn't too fun.
Yeah.
But it's still. you don't turn it off and in anger scream to your wife, I'm never doing this again.
Okay.
Because you're losing everybody.
I don't get emotionally invested into these.
Yeah.
I didn't think you were going to address this.
I like
you're going to address this?
Emotional and financial.
Yeah. You attach your emotional only with the financial.
That's the only way he can get the emotions to rise to the surface is by connecting something financial.
And then it's always anger.
No other emotion. No sadness.
When I win, it's relief.
There's also one
that's
other,
not even a good emotion.
There's one other emotion that you've been saying a lot at the end of days here. It is there's an adjective that he uses. There's a word that he uses when you're here, and it's disgust.
No.
He says, I'm disgusted, or this disgusts
that's
me,
pretty,
or this is
harsh.
Disgusting.
Yeah, but
disgust.
I'm going too harsh.
And then you whip, really, and then you're disgusting. Flogging, and then you're beating yourself, right? And then you're punishing yourself.
God damn, this sounds like a terrible workplace.
Yeah, it's been rough. We have a bodega full of rotten snacks.
I can snack. Snack through the misery. Yeah.
It's weird that we didn't see that. We're like, we're by ourselves. How good could this be?
We don't have a middle person.
There's literally no buffer. There's no buffer here, so now no one talks during the days.
And then when Daniel left, I was like, oh, shit. I knew this would happen.
Fuck you. Where's my great toilet paper?
You know, we're just laughing at shit. That's it. People get nervous. They're like, I heard you. Are you okay? Like, people will text me. Mom will be like, I heard you.
We can't fuck around because then people, they'll message you and be like, hey, maybe you and Tom just need a little time off. I'm like, hold on a second. Everything's fine.
Session.
We're fucking around, man.
Or making fun of small little things that are normal in people's lives.
Obviously, owning a small business, I would say this. It's never been a better time to own a small business because it's really fucking hard.
Yeah, here's the thing. Even just going to work and living normal life is stressful and
you know that. The job market out there is
it's more stressful on one side of things. You know what I'm saying? Like, and that's the thing. There's nothing that there's no easy path, I don't think.
Fun Friday, everybody. Friday. I'm glad I came. Weren't we talking about fun and joy?
Yeah.
Now we're talking about work is miserable and disgusting, and we all work till we die.
No, that's not. But that's the thing. finding some sort of joy I think everybody's trying to do that, right?
Yeah. I think that's the number one thing.
You got to find the joy.
What have you been finding joy in recently?
My dog is joyful. We spend a lot of time with my dog.
I love your puppy. She's a good puppy.
How was y'all's cruise?
Oh God, it was good, but the boat was humongous and awesome, but very hard to navigate.
Got lost on the boat.
It was more like an ocean liner style. So it was like very difficult to navigate. It wasn't like the standard Carnival where you get the three tunnels and then they put food by the tunnels. You just go up the tunnels and eat.
You know what I was impressed by is that the customs finally figured out a different system and then you just walk up. Did you have that?
That happened to us, and I thought it might have just been a ding, ding, we're cool, bro, scenario. I didn't realize that that was just the standard now.
Yeah.
We got right off, and I was like, just keep walking. Don't say nothing. Let's go.
There's no more having to show a human anything. You just walk, and it's a facial scan, and then you walk right off. And that is what enabled these giant mega ships
you can renew your passport online now.
Is it all online?
That's crazy good,
right?
If you can do that,
you can vote from space. Did you know that? Absentee ballot. I'm fucking serious.
That's dope.
Those two astronauts that are stranded in space, they're voting.
Well, can't you just tell the person?
They should be able to say,
how are they
Couldn't
able to
I
do it?
Couldn't I just tell the person who the hell I want to vote for? I gotta go to my polling station, right?
Well, how are they doing it from space?
Oh, they're giving them some specialized PDF file, clicking on their selections. I'm like, well, send me the PDF.
I feel like that's a massive waste of money, right?
For sure.
Although it would be awesome if they made them roll it into a scroll and then launch it.
No, with a bow and arrow.
Atmosphere.
Well, that's my point. It's like if they can get that back and forth.
Yeah. Okay. No, I know. Listen, the government is changing
USPS
things.
Can't even get me my absentee ballot, but somehow they're sending it to space.
I know. Well, yeah.
I don't know. My wife votes for me. Is that allowed? Could you just like, I'm just like, yeah, just fill it out. It's
can
fine.
You, can you imagine? Yeah.
Yeah, it's fine. Just
fill
do
in
it.
The bubbles.
Just do it. You know what I like. Yeah. You know the way I, and you know the way I treat people. So just take how I am and how I, and the things, my values. Yeah. You know my values. You know how I feel. So just vote with your, just do your best.
I'll go one step further. Anybody out there that's listening to me could vote for me.
Okay. Let's offer, we should sell our votes, dude. Yeah. Can we do that?
Everybody
can we sell
though.
Our votes?
Oh, I'll sell my vote right
I'll
out.
I'll sell my vote right now, too.
Don't how much let money? Mo see this part of the
how
show.
How much money can we make for the show by selling our votes?
I'm glad I'm not on the show anymore.
We knew that.
That's what we were trying to get you to say. Release the balloons. You win $1,000.
And the balloons. We knew it.
Mission accomplished.
And I'm dressed like George W. Bush. I'm on an aircraft carrier.
We'll drive everybody away. And then next, the listeners.
That's the last step.
Yeah, save the best for last. Yeah. Wait till we drive you guys away.
Well, I think we can do it.
I think we can
do it. That's medium infinity. You know, we just drive you away from the show.
Nah, but there'll always be like five crazy ones. They'll
might
never
be,
stop.
Might
who's
be
that?
Oh, there.
Oh, come here, you rascal Padishaw.
My wife's pee. He's not going anywhere.
No. We could do anything.
Was
man,
he
that
on
guy,
the cruise?
No.
You know, he was not on the cruise. I think his wife.
Who partied the hardest?
I think DeBerry Joe.
DeBerry Joe.
DeBerry Joe lost his soul in a Sailor Moon Speedo.
Yeah. He was doing a Sailor Moon Speedo. He got so wasted that Cadillac Pat
won't talk to
was
him
hiding from him.
What?
Yeah. Yeah, Cadillac.
He's like, I can't take it anymore.
Oh, Pat's the nicest man in the world.
We have a rift in our unfortunate gang.
Oh.
And we now we have a fight on the R team. And DeBerry Joe is now not talking to Cadillac Pat. We have to broker a deal somewhere down the line, try to get them back together.
How did you guys fare as far as partying?
I didn't
party
throw
less,
up.
Party more?
Partied less. I didn't throw up, but I was drunk too much. It was not. It's so exhausting. It's absolutely exhausting.
It's exhausting.
It's and stairs. It's just so many stairs.
The elevators in the MSC. We already talked about this, but it's
sorry,
like,
no. I
haven't
it's
been
totally
here.
Fine. It's fine.
Tell me what you want to talk about.
I don't really have anything.
Yeah, I got enough.
Dan hit a whole list.
Yeah. I got a list of stuff. I got some stuff.
I wrote down Sam Semantics. Ask her what's up. And I did that already. So then after that, I was like, right. We'll see where it's
we'll
going.
Cross that off. Look, Instagram pics, cross
you,
that off.
I told you not to get go to the fucking egg stuff, A material first.
Then it's why I'm like, oh, we're drowning in our business is failing.
Quick, insult the listeners.
We're talking about how our business is failing again. Yeah.
Fuck you, motherfuckers. Release the balloons. I like this.
Eat my wife's pussy. Yay. He loves it. He's laughing his ass
Crystal
off. He's like, I'll never leave.
Padishaw's dog comes in with Crocs on its feet. I'm like, okay, things are back to normal. We're good.
Anyway, so.
You want to talk about Uno? Because, I mean.
What's that, Sam?
What happened with Uno?
Yeah, just you ask her because you.
Okay.
Oh, God.
Like, okay. You lay it out there because I was playing Uno with my family last night. I thought I knew the rules of Uno, and I went real hard on Maisie, and she did cry and storm off to her room, but, like, I don't let her win, and if I win, you know, I win.
Right.
That's just the way it goes.
Fair
you gotta,
and square.
I'm trying to,
yeah,
we're raising,
fair and square.
We're raising adults, Michelle Obama.
Yeah. And it is because Max gets emotional when he loses.
Yeah.
And you're
sort of
like,
You've seen it.
I'm like, you just gotta take it.
You just gotta take
it. And then it's like, no matter how hard it feels, like, it happened. Deal with
you
it.
You got to deal with it. Yeah.
It's hard to do that.
So May had a card, and she was getting ready. She had one, and she had two cards in her hand, and she went to put a card down, and she was still holding a card. And I gave her a beat, and then I yelled Uno like that. And I was like, I didn't say this, but like. The way I yelled it was as if I was like, I fucking got you, motherfucker! Like, chopping my crotch. I'm like, yeah, I fucking you, boom! Mock shaka. You know, I was doing the whole shaka-laka. Everything. She's like, this isn't the way it works. I was going to say it. Right? The whole thing.
Sure.
And then Tom says that another person saying Uno in an attempt to catch another person not saying Uno is not a thing.
What?
It's not a thing.
Is that what you thought? Yeah.
Sharding Randy is here. So, full transparency. We do have an intelligent human in here, and he is.
Well,
nodding.
You can go to the rules.
You can go to the rules.
Because I have done this with my family.
I got the rule book out, and I went to the bathroom. Well, I went to the bathroom to smoke my True Leave one here, but I was reading through it as fast as I'm going through the thing, going as fast as I can. And I don't see shit in there, but then I was like, it's in there.
So there's one.
Because he's been rubbing off of me a lot more lately.
In the evolution of Uno and learning, it's going to go one step further, and you'll find out when it happens. Is that my family went through all this as well.
See, the chat room saying we're both wrong now. The chat room saying it is a thing.
No.
It's not.
I'll tell you. I went through this. It was a long van family.
Jesus Christ.
Multiple day discussion because we were playing Uno every night. Yeah. And then we were doing
I knew you would know this too. I came in this morning. I was like,
They do play a lot of games as a family.
Yeah, they do. But Maisie's still mad at me. I mean, she's just fucking livid.
Yeah, we were playing poker for a while. And then,
the family-friendly game poker.
And then it got into real money poker where the boys were getting, we're all getting $10 out and then playing tournament style.
That's bad ass.
Out of their piggy banks. They got, literally like $1,000 of dollars.
We all know Tom doesn't lock his doors. We're all going to go grab his piggy banks.
Some of it is in a bank account.
Maisie's got a couple hundo in her bank, and we are forever taking cash out of that thing. I don't even know. We're law. I don't even know what we're in arrears to. I just assume
Crystal has taken a lot of cash out of the piggy bank, and she's like, I'll get them back. And I'm like, I think you said that like 10 times.
I am.
That's fine.
I mean, we have taken the same. I've given her the same money twice on the same piece. I've given her hey, 20. And here's the same fucking 20. I think she's had three tooth. It's 120.
I would think Maisie, though, would count her money and keep track of what's in her piggy bank.
She kind of does, but she's really worried
about. She's got too much going on.
She has a card. She has a card, and she's more worried about the card than the cash. Which sort of makes sense if you think about it. Like, I'll count cash because I'm a fucking old man. But Maisie, she's only worried about, she can check the balance of her card on her phone and on her iPad.
Right.
So it's like, I'm like, I'm okay with
convenience of the balance.
Yeah. She's definitely like a 21st century digital gal.
So with Uno, we were playing it the way that I knew when I was a kid. If you say Uno before the other person says it, then they get penalized, draw two. And so we were doing that, and the problem was that I'd go to even put my card down, everybody's screaming Uno, then I was like, wait, well, hold on, well, what's the, like, when is my turn officially over?
When I put the card down?
Yeah, is it when my fingertip literally leaves the card, and then I'm now in only possession of one? I was like, there has to be some exact rule here, and then so,
bust out the books.
So we started reading it, and then you calling it out before the other person is something made up that's an aftermarket thing.
Like a house rule someone made up.
Yes, a house rule.
The thing that people are mistaking is that it's just you not saying it. So, for instance, if I have one, if I have two cards and I play a card, and now I have an Uno, I am on Uno.
And you don't say it.
If I just sit there, then you get penalized. You know,
okay, so here's
the next person goes to go, right?
This is the problem with that. So then we read the official rules and are like, all right, this is how we're going to play. But then the problem is, when is your turn officially over, where then that penalizes you the two cards for not saying Uno?
Right.
So because the problem is
You've inhaled and exhaled completely,
the vans got to the point where we were like, the next person, if the next person touches the deck with their finger, that implies that previous person's turn is up, and therefore they're penalized if they don't say Uno. Then here's the problem. That I would.
Oh, people are going to try to put their card down.
Yes,
quick.
Yeah. And the person next to would grab, and I'd be like, wait, my turn wasn't up. Like, I did not relinquish my turn, and then it was this huge deal, and then we finally changed the rules in the van house to say, no, the saying Uno is no longer a rule. Then it made it unfun.
Yeah. You have a lot of unfun in your life. I'm seeing a pattern here. Yeah.
And then I was like, what have we done?
But in the official rules, it does say that you have to say Uno. And if the next person goes without,
I have it in the chat
room.
They call
Uno on them to get penalized.
Here's the rules. Right? This is Tracy from the Uno website. She says, and this is from twitch.tv/TomandDanLive. Before playing your second to last card, you must say Uno. Your cart has to touch the discard pile before anyone can call you out for not saying Uno. If you place the card in the discard pile and don't say Uno, the opponents can call you out until the next player begins their turn. The next player's turn begins when the player draws a card from the draw pile or drawing a card from their own hand.
Now, what you're finding, listen, if you read the back of the Uno box, it does not say this.
Well, I read the little, there's a pamphlet inside. There's a little booklet.
Yeah, yeah. And then so the other person saying it before you, but that's the problem. When is your turn over?
Yeah. And that, I get what you're saying. And all we're arguing is the whole idea of yelling Uno.
Like, is it three Mississippis after I put the card down?
Yeah. I say alligators now, too, instead of Mississippi. And I don't know why I never did that. But, like, it's so much more Floridian to be like, one alligator, two alligator, right? So much better.
Yeah, yeah, but then why are you varying from the Mississippi?
Yeah, yeah.
Just do it gives me joy, man.
Can't change my ways. Don't teach old dog new
just
tricks.
Just why are you trying to be unique?
Who the fuck do you think you are?
Yeah, yeah. Step in line with the rest of us. We're all Mississippi here.
Anyway, we're all Mississippi
look at this guy.
Here,
he's
baby.
A fucking alligator over here. Yeah.
You can't take the fun out of things and overanalyze them. That's the main point.
Well, that one, yeah, and I'm going to have to
so
apologize.
So what we just did, overanalyzing the rules of Uno,
but it was wrong.
Just took the fun out of the
show.
I
got it wrong. Like, I did it wrong. Like, I shouldn't have yelled it, right? Like, that's the thing that people, I think, don't think we understand. We get that the person saying Uno has to be said. We get that.
Mm-hmm.
We're just saying the whole you yelling at somebody else, like, Uno, and you call it for them, that's not a thing.
Yeah, yeah. And then when is it the other person's turn? You know, it's like there is a small margin
found,
of argument.
We found the flaw in Uno. We found the
flaw. Yeah, but then if you take that away, it makes it not fun.
What was that fake Uno that they had for a while? It was like, there's Rook. Does anybody remember Rook? No. I think that's like a version of Uno. Then there's, obviously there was Uno. Then there's all the variations of Uno. Then there was, it was like a cheap Uno. I can't remember the name of it, but it was like a knockoff of Uno.
They've come out with, like, there's a Dose. We played
Dose.
That. Not as fun.
Dose. Yeah.
Double the fun, huh?
Yeah. No. They put some extra cards
in Charles there. Got it. Skip-bo. Yeah.
Skip-bo.
Skip-bo. That's it. Yeah. What is Skip-bo, though? What was that one?
There's no need for another one. You got Uno. You got some other
number
ones.
Number one.
Just
Uno. It's the best.
The only two board games my father ever played, Uno. He counted it as a board game.
Yeah.
And Sorry. That's it.
Monopoly.
Yeah, no.
Monopolies and Sorry.
Sorry. Sorry was the big one in our house.
A lot of fights in Monopoly.
Yeah, a lot of fights in Sorry. You know, when you bump the person
and
go back.
Throwing the table across the room in my house.
My bad. Yeah.
You throw the whole table?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, man.
Yeah. Well, ashes all over the goddamn board.
At least the name
they're
of
smoking.
The game was Sorry.
Oh, yeah, inside. Burn marks on Boardwalk.
That is a wonderful punk rock band name.
That is a great band name.
Yeah, Burn Marks on Boardwalk.
Yeah, yeah.
It's hard to say, too, which is good.
Also, it is socioeconomic when no one wants to be the banker. Because you're not good at math. Listen,
I was never in the
Van household. They were like, banker, who's gonna who wants to? Because I think in some households,
Crystal,
like
the go-to.
In mine, you know, like I'm just saying, in you know, back in the day,
childhood Van household.
Yeah. I'm not at all good at banking, so I was never the banker.
Yeah, you need someone organized, responsible. Hard to find.
Did you guys even play?
Yeah. They a little bit. So, Sam, because we're going to take a break. We're going to come back. We're going to talk to Tuttle because
I'm sorry that you're on this day that you get to talk to Tuds.
Daniel described to me something Tuttle's doing, and then I completely flipped.
Buried in concrete again, please. Bring it back. Nostalgia is back, baby.
Sam, you have no idea. Do you want me to even say it, or are we just going to let him?
No. Tuttle never texts me an outline of what exactly he's going to do. So you tell, because what Daniel told me this, I was like, we got to talk to him.
Is he a stunt boy again?
I mean,
full on.
Has he got
him
like you? Is he confirmed?
Of course you like it.
Because I haven't heard from him. I sent him the link and everything. I haven't heard nothing from him. So.
He said he...
So supposedly they are doing a Bubba the Love Sponge content house in an Airbnb in Celebration.
Oh, man.
It is the entire cast of the show, plus some of their wacky characters.
Mm-hmm.
And Tuttle is sleeping out on the lawn in a tent. in some sort of zany costume. And he's also going to be getting into a money machine that has $4,000 in it.
Hell yeah. And I've always wanted to be in a money machine.
And I think he has to grab the money with, like, his butthole.
Oh.
Like, yeah. And then they're going to have slingshots, and they're going to fire frozen fruit at the intern's assholes. And they're going to tase each other's balls.
In celebration?
Yeah, yeah.
They're going to stand for this?
Yeah, like, and then didn't he say they were firing fruit at each other's buttholes?
I feel like the HOA in celebration is going to have some issues.
There was something about...
That's why they're doing it, Sam. The brilliance of the sponge.
And why didn't I think of this?
I'm telling you right now, the sponge has got it. He's on to something. The sponge is on it, dude. And he's going to be firing fruit into their interns, men and women interns. Tuttle's like 50.
God,
he's a little older than me.
But Sam, okay, let me convince you why this is good now. Because I've been on this new kick.
Sam could swing by there, get some, all you have to do is swing by their poster board, maybe get some clicks for the Patreon, right?
I've been on this new kick. We did a kind of a show about it last week where I'm like,
really need that? Who likes that?
No.
Not a new kick.
I got the family, got the standard, I'm trying to be healthier, whatever, do this shit. And then it's like, oh, okay. And then it's like, all right, well,
what's the new kick?
Yeah, but it's like, that's boring.
Yeah,
it's just standard.
Yeah. Okay. So what's the new kick?
Oh, wait, maybe I'll live a little bit longer. Maybe not. Who knows? Yeah. It seems to me all kind of fucking luck anyway.
Yeah.
People
it's
get
all
diseases
willy-nilly.
And shit.
Yeah, yeah.
Anyway, so then, but then I see other people like Cadillac Pat and Tuttle.
Yeah.
That Tuttle has the opportunity.
He's living life.
No, not that he's it's nothing I'd want to do. I'm not saying I'd want to be in his position.
Right.
I would never say that.
Correct.
You understand me.
Okay.
Right? But I'm saying that
I don't think he wants to be in his position. To tell you the truth.
He could turn into a legend. And I said this about Cadillac Pat. Yeah. He could be the legendary stunt
guy. You're obsessed with legends.
He is.
Because it lives past.
Yeah.
Well, if you think about it, I know he doesn't like for us to psychoanalyze him, but I mean, a lot of what he has been told, the Van Way is his entire life, he's had his family tell him tall tales.
Yeah.
And so he's trying to leave. Yeah. Like, I feel
the
like
Tom
you,
Van,
you
the legend of Tom
leave,
Van.
Yeah, you want to leave
it's
a tall
boring
tale.
It's boring now. It was like, this guy.
You got to do something crazy, man.
Yeah, I don't know if I have it in me, though. I don't know if I have it in me.
You know what you got to do?
You got it back there somewhere.
You know what you
got
to do?
You got it in there somewhere.
You got to suck Shart and Randy's dick.
Yeah.
You got to do it, man.
Right, on camera?
It'll make you a legend.
That will make you a legend.
He's doing this for you, Randy. You want to be legendary or not?
It would be like, holy shit.
Gabe Toberfest is right around the corner.
I can help father your sons. I'll help father your sons after the transition. Because once you go there, you're going to love it too much. And you're never coming back.
I don't know. I don't think I love it.
And then you'll become Dick Sucking Tom, the new character on the show.
I don't
be a legend. That's all you want, right? Doesn't matter how you get there.
Well, I'm just saying.
Diddy, pretty legendary.
Yeah, he will be legendary.
No, not a good
legend. Not to be a horrible legend.
Not all legends are good legends.
That's true.
No,
heroes wear capes.
That's right.
No, that's infamous. There's a difference. Like, a legend, I think, insinuates that it's a good thing.
It's a good
thing. No? Well, because I wouldn't call bad people a legend. I'd call them infamous.
Well, legend, I don't think legend has...
Well, famous and infamous are different.
I don't know if legend has... I think maybe we have applied goodness to it.
Yeah.
I don't know if the word legend...
Like the legend of Blackbeard. He wasn't a great guy.
Yeah.
Or if you say, oh man, Diddy's parties are legendary. I mean, that could be good and bad, right?
Yeah. I guess, yeah. I don't know. I always assumed that it implied, that it was some sort of...
I wonder if we did that.
A positive comment.
I wonder
but just not... definitely not negative, let's say. Like, I wouldn't call Hitler a legend, right? You wouldn't,
The legend of Hitler?
Yeah, it sounds bad saying that.
Because it is bad.
Well, I'm saying,
his legend was not good.
You'd call him infamous. Like, that is more of a description. I don't know. Listen.
I'm going to ask ChatGPT.
So your new kick is you need to become a legend?
No, not me.
Oh.
I just...
You just want to talk.
Hey, turn your radio down. Who's this?
Who's that?
Yeah,
is that me?
Yeah.
Yes.
Who is this?
Hey, BDM Easy.
What's going on, Easy?
Easy.
Hey, man, it's so good to see Sam in the studio. I miss you.
Oh,
I had a quick, I know it's about a year late, but I had a manatee story for you guys.
Oh, well, you happen to call on Manatee Friday. Let's do it. Let's roll.
This is Manatee Week.
All right.
Why is it a year late?
Manatees are slow.
Tom, I'm just like you.
That's the worst thing you could have said. Tom's never wanted to say "fuck you, motherfucker" more than to anyone. You're ruining the show. Okay, continue your story.
God damn it!
All right, so my mom. I grew up in Sarasota. My mom worked at Moat Marine. They have a public aquarium, and in '98 or '99, they opened a marine mammal center, and they got two manatees, Hugh and Buffett, brothers. And so, like, last year I was visiting my mom, and somehow I brought up Snooty, who was this poor manatee in captivity in, down in Naples or something.
Snooty is...
Do you know Snooty?
No, but I love...
Who doesn't know Snooty?
I love the name Snooty.
That's the podcast mascot.
Sir, did you really just ask if we knew Snooty? As if we know the names of manatees?
Everyone knows about Snooty.
Everybody.
He's the poor thing. He lives in a legend. This depressing...
Sam's lying to you, sir. No one knows anything about any manatee's names.
God damn.
I'm sorry.
He's trying to dial that back. We're in the process of dialing that back. He doesn't know what came over.
Sorry, I'll hold that one.
See what you made me do?
Your wife knows about Snooty. Everyone knows Snooty. The poor thing was in a sad little...
His true feelings just came out.
I'm sorry.
I mean, Snooty, you know, if you type in the word Snooty, it is the first thing that comes up. So
I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
The legend of Snooty.
Everybody does know Snooty. Yeah. I shouldn't
just
have said
Tom's
that.
The only
apologize.
One that does
we
it.
Apologize.
Okay.
Yeah.
Anyway, I brought up Snooty to my, about a year ago, I brought up Snooty to my mother because he passed away in a sad little dirty swimming pool.
Oh, and then
my mom was like, "Oh, did you hear about Hugh and Buffett?" And I was like, "What?" So Hugh and Buffett were the manatees at in Moat Marine in Sarasota. And my mom, my sweet little mother, started explaining to me, well, you know, sometimes when male manatees are in captivity, about twice a year they get kind of frisky and aggressive. And unfortunately, Hugh is not with us anymore. And so I was like, Buffett butt fucked Hugh to death? And that's literally what happened. He butt fucked his brother to death. And
no.
I'm sorry I came here today. You know?
I knew you'd be sorry. We have those words.
You did this to ruin my joy.
You fell right into our trap. You fell right into our manatee bottle trap.
Yeah, I saw you out there having too much fun. I'm like, bring her back.
Bring her back.
You're going to show her the real world.
Butt fucked.
And you know what he said? He's like, and line up the manatee butt fuck Carla.
Jesus
Christ, man. We're going to destroy any charge.
I thought they were the most docile creatures on earth. Didn't we read that they haven't ever even shown aggression ever?
They're human cowards.
I don't think that. I
think your mom was misinformed.
I think your mom lied to you.
No, guys, Google it. Look it up. Hugh and Buffett, Moat Marine.
Hugh and Buffett, Moat Marines.
He effed his brother to death.
Oh, when you. What do you.
They just released the details.
Okay, he just rammed him.
Hold on, he didn't
butt fuck him to death.
If he butt fucked him to death, I expect to see an open wound ass and then blood.
There it is.
I need some blood in a manatee dick, and I want the manatee to use his fin to hold his dick and be like, "See what I've done? You see what I've fucking done?" Like, yeah, I want it to be extreme.
He just rammed him a bunch of times until he died in some way. He didn't actually have intercourse.
The necropsy report. Hold on. Just hold on, man.
We're looking at it.
The necropsy report states that Hugh died from a 14.5-centimeter rip in his colon caused by a sexual encounter by another male manatee named Buffett. Buffett is Hugh's brother.
No.
Hold on.
Buffett.
You know what this tells me? Jimmy Buffett was gay. Dude, that's what I hear. That's what I heard.
So
this man tells no lies.
Yeah, wow.
Thank you, Sam.
I love you, and good riddance, Butler.
Hold on. I got nothing against Butler. Wow. He didn't read my text messages.
You heard it here.
And he's out.
Wow. God damn. That,
unbelievable. That is breaking news.
That is horrific.
That is... But hey, if I were going to be legendary...
Well, you hold on. What happened?
You're only legendary if you're butt-fucked to death.
Can manatees
trying to pull you around.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, easy to die from a propeller.
But guess...
Anybody can do that. But butt-fucking to death?
But guess who's legendary?
Legend.
Not Buffett. Hugh. Wait, Buffett is legendary.
Okay, yeah,
wait,
yeah.
Which one?
Oh, yeah. Which one's a murderer?
Hugh is not. He was weak.
Okay.
Because
yeah.
He died.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. The one that killed. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah. Which I, got killed.
Look, you Buffett? Can't. Look, I'll tell you right now, and this may be a bold statement, but if you're fucking me in the ass, I ain't gonna let you kill me.
And why are they tougher than that? That killed them. Like yeah. You think?
Well, I don't think they normally get fucked in the ass.
Right.
You
know, I don't think their colons were meant for.
Yeah, this is
what does a manatee dick look like?
It's apparently 14 inches.
I was about to say, let's go to the bathroom, and then I was gonna scream.
Oh my god!
That's why you shouldn't be here.
Yeah. Yeah, you're right. We missed a prime EJ joke.
We really did.
We're losing it, Sam.
Wait a minute. You swam against EJ. What's his dick look like?
Oh, man.
We could have done that.
All right.
Wasn't he drinking on the cruise?
Yeah. They always got divorced.
How is drunk EJ?
He got into a lot of trouble with his wife.
Did
yeah,
he?
Yeah. He's more aggressive.
I'll leave it at that. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. He gets more like
he went butt-fucking his brother.
No bullshit. He went to the bar and then was yelling at other couples. Like there were like groups of like bachelor party women that were like,
oh sure,
like, you know, like being being all about themselves, and he would go there and argue with them about how vapid and stupid they are, and then he would post about it online.
Yeah, yeah. It's already like he goes back
goddamn
to his
villain.
90s college days. That's probably why he doesn't drink. Which he's like, and I was asking him, he's like, I'm drinking today for the first time in 20 years. And I'm like, don't do that.
Yeah, don't do that.
Yeah,
I'm going to butt fuck a manatee. You'll see.
Just like, just be done with
Leave
it.
Leave it be.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You don't need to, it's not a good thing.
Yeah, yeah. Like, look
it's
back.
No, it's poison.
Yeah, it doesn't help.
And it's not going to help anything.
I can say that as a person that I can see where it is in certain areas beneficial, but it's not a good thing.
20 years.
It is not a good thing. Yeah.
Yeah. If you decided it's not for you, just be done with it. It's never going to be
for
you.
Doesn't get better as you get older.
Yeah.
Unless you're Buffett the manatee. You got to try it.
Well, what happened? Why was he the only violent manatee?
I've never heard of this.
No, I haven't either.
Because you would think there have been
this
lots.
This was the first
time.
When
we went to Blue Springs, we did manatee research, and we're like, there were no... Didn't we read that there were no...
aggressive manatees.
Like, ever. No reports of it at all. How come we didn't come across this?
It's not natural. They're doing some studies, and they're actually... Supposedly, they are doing some studies on Buffett, and they think that maybe it was...
CTE.
He had CTE because he played with the Ravens for about seven years. He was a running back for the Ravens. So.
And he put his suit in the dumpster.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, man.
He's your hero? I don't know nothing about it. Anyway, all right, let's take a break. When we come back, we'll talk to Tuttle.
Yes.
Because I still don't know what the hell, like, this whole thing is for.
No.
If it's just is it for charity or some sort? Or
I don't think so.
I think the sponge does a lot of charity.
Yeah, I mean, he does. But I think when he's doing when he's shooting fruit at people's buttholes, that's not a charity.
They probably don't want to be associated.
Yeah, that's not a charity thing.
This is for, like, colon cancer.
Could be. Origami Angel.
Ooh, love Origami Angel.
New Origami Angel. The name of the song is Dirty. Dirty Mirror Selfie. It goes. It's a good tune. We'll be back with more A Mediocre Time with Tom and Dan right after this. 1, 2, go. I like the glass they used at the ending there instead of symbols. You know, it's kind of cool. That was the Slackers. Welcome back to A Mediocre Time with Tom and Dan. I am Dan.
I'm Tom. Samantha Haar's here.
Hello.
From the Semantics Podcast.
Yes.
Sign up, Patreon yourself.
Yep.
Where can people help support the Semantics Pod?
Yeah, you can just go to semanticspodcast.com. Everything is there. Or patreon.com/semantics. You can follow and subscribe our Twitch, twitch.tv/semanticsmedia. I'm on there 3 times a week, Monday, Wednesday, and Friday around 9 a.m. And I do a streaming show called Sipping with Sammy. So if you want to tune in for that.
It is very fun. I tune in at times. You know, if I'm here in the morning, I'll put it on. It's very cool. Yeah, you can get your dose of silly news.
Yeah.
Sometimes some crazy news.
And that's
300th episode of Semantics coming out this
weekend.
Oh,
really?
Yeah.
That doing 300 episodes of a podcast is difficult.
It's a massive deal.
Yeah.
It's a massive deal.
And I don't know, like, if people actually think about what that takes. to even
anybody can do it.
Not well, everybody is doing it now. I mean, everybody's doing it now.
300 is
Tuttle's been on more than that.
Yeah. Well, speaking of which,
he used to do the Tuttle Daily podcast.
I've got him. Do you want? Should I pull him? Ladies and gentlemen,
there he is.
I don't know where he's live from, but we'll just put him up here. Ladies and gentlemen, it is the greatest radio stuntman of all time, our good friend Tuttle.
Can you guys hear me okay?
Yeah, you sound good.
You
dude.
Always sound
so
good.
So, Tuttle, tell me what you're doing.
He's the best in the business.
I'm not.
Yeah. So, we're getting right into this. No making out, no foreplay. We're just
massage his ego a little, Tom.
After I mentioned to Tom that you may or may not be doing something that, you know, it makes Tom happy. Like, there's very few things that make Tom happy. But
that's
one of the
true.
Things that I absolutely know makes Tom happy is when you...
People are miserable.
and when you are, like, firing frozen fruit into your butthole.
Yeah, stunts
when
it off.
When you're tasing your balls.
Stunt daddy.
You need to do that.
Yeah, when you're... Yeah, like, all of... So where are you... Are you... I had heard that you are back in the game. Where are we at? Are you back in the Bubba the Love Sponge stunt game?
Okay. Have I really ever quit the stunt game?
No.
I mean, it's the only thing that's ever been faithful to me.
Oh,
right?
Yes, that's true. That's absolutely true. Your wife left you, but stunting did not.
Come on.
Stunting never left you.
I actually left when she went up to her sister's baby shower in New Jersey, and I just packed up my stuff and moved out.
Yeah. Let's not talk
about it. This is a great place to start. Thank you, Sam.
We got to make sure we get this story straight.
How much were you masturbating after she left you? Probably a lot,
No, I don't want to talk about that.
Yeah.
No, come on.
I was starting to get like rashes in certain places.
Well, also, you let your hygiene go to hell where you just like... You're just coming anywhere, letting it dry.
My carpet crunched every time I got out of bed.
Yeah, I know.
I just want to ask Tuttle about what he's doing because I,
give you joy.
No, is that it's. I kind of turned around on this because there was a time where me and Daniel, we had a serious talk to each other. We're like, we got to tell Tuttle, like, it's time to hang this up.
We tell this nerd to knock this shit off.
Yeah, yeah. And then I'm like, you know, this radio business is not for you. It's like constant negativity, your anus.
You got to make it your anus. This guy's got a fucked up anus because of it.
And then it's like, it's going to be hard to find long-term love with your, you know, all this
next
stuff.
Thing you know, you're dead like a manatee.
And then to hang it up and just get a normal
Tuttle,
job.
Did you ever hear of Hugh and Buffett the manatees? Joke. And Hugh and Buffett the manatees were brothers, and Hugh fucked his brother Buffett to death.
Yeah, I've heard that. Like, they can actually, because a lot of people forget, manatees have to be able to breathe oxygen, and if you're just constantly getting gang raped by your brother... and he's not letting you out for air, you're going to die.
No, he died from a 14.5-inch hole in his colon.
A rupture.
Yeah.
Oh, no. Oof.
Yeah.
All right.
The worst way to die.
Yeah, yeah, that is the worst way to die. Yeah. And from your own brother.
Yeah.
Which, like that Mr. Hands guy with the horse.
Which doesn't really support my, hey, you got to keep doing these anus.
Hold on, we're turning back around.
I'll cut this part
out. Correct the steering.
Okay, continue.
Anyway, back to my point.
Yeah, back to your point.
Okay, so what's going on? And Bubba had this genius idea where we were going to go to around, and we're going to do a content house, and we were going to do an appearance at a local establishment for where we had the most downloads, the people that were donating the most bits or super chats on YouTube. And we decided to go to Orlando. And that's something that we're going to be doing on November 16th. We're going to be...
mark your calendars.
Yeah, it's kind of two-phased, okay? We're doing a content house. They rented... an Airbnb and...
Wait a minute, is this the T&D Airbnb?
Hold on, did you rent our Air T&D? Oh my God,
it's
Bubba
a content
the Love
house
Sponge.
Now.
Bubba the Love Sponge is going to be shitting in a Homer bucket.
It's already full
of
cum, so it's fine.
Would you guys let us use the...
I'll let you, but you have to talk to Tom. But I give you my vote. So, it's a yes for me, dog.
Before we continue, Tuttle, explain to me now, is
what's the content?
Is Bubba's show, is it primarily a podcast YouTube show? Or does it still get aired on terrestrial radio? Like,
yes, it does. Okay. It's about, I'd say about 6 markets right now.
Oh, that's great.
Okay.
I think the furthest one is over in Reno.
Now, what's the bit, like, is it beneficial for him to be aired on the radio anymore? Or, like, he's got his own audience that's, like, his YouTube and his Twitch
followers. He's got a huge Twitch audience.
Well, I mean, he still thinks that terrestrial radio has a little bit of value.
Yeah.
But at the same time, he knows that the streaming platform is the way to go now, because if you look at all of the terrestrial radio people, they're kind of like moving a little bit towards doing more online content, podcasting, extra content that people have to go to a website and download on a regular basis. So
yeah. Just streaming, well, streaming, or
I'm beyond streaming now. I'm to the point where there's no content now.
Yeah,
but I'm out of content.
Anyway, Tuttle. So back to this content house. So they're renting an Airbnb, and who's going to be in there? And tell me your part.
This is like Tiffany's sleepover all over again.
It is very similar.
Oh, smash a mirror.
Yeah.
Oh, I mean, man, Tom was being like, I mean, he wasn't an old man at that time, man, he was taking full advantage.
That dude
Party
was fun.
Tom.
That dude was fun, but you know what? He had too good of a compass on him. He could have really fucked some wild bitches back in the day. This guy could have cleaned up. You saw him. But
I think you could have.
But he's
a
good man. He's virtuous, and he wouldn't do that to his loving wife, but he could have.
You could have nailed that Gina the scene girl that we had in Tiffany's. You really, really could have, but you were, you know, very faithful and, you know, maybe.
Were you faithful, Tuds?
Me? Hell no.
Oh,
no, come on.
So you cheated on your wife.
Stop talking about it.
I never cheated on my wife. Well, I mean, technically, what's the definition of cheating?
Okay.
All right. Don't bring it up.
This guy's got the
I just want to ask him about what he's doing.
Okay,
and
we'll ask him then.
So
what's ended up happening is some of the highest contributors of the Bubba Army, the ones that have qualified to go to the Bubba Army Radio yearly party that happens around Christmas.
God, we don't even do that for our staff. we did it one time with Ross and Sam. We took them to Ale House. It was fucking terrible.
Like, for you to be invited to the party, you have to hit a plateau of the amount of money that you cheer or super chat on YouTube or donate on PayPal. We keep a running tab of, you know, what people have made.
Okay.
So this is like, write this down. Are you jotting this down?
Yes.
Am I correct in that? Are these the same Super Chat and YouTube listeners that you guys have where you guys made statues of them?
Yeah, we have golden bust of our biggest
contributors. They have like statues. Remember, you go to Hollywood Studios and remember when they used to have all the, and then they had Bill Cosby and they took him out. Yeah. It's all like bronze busts of all these different Hollywood icons.
Okay.
Bubba the Love Sponge has this of his listeners. It would be like if we had in our lobby
it's a statue.
Yeah, but if we had a statue of Eat My Wife's Pussy. He's like a big bust of him with a
Wait, if we're gonna have any statue, it would be of Eric the Roofman.
Eric Roofman.
He's giving us the
or
money.
His wife.
Eat My Wife's Pussy just gives us a bunch of stories.
stories are my currency, sir.
We're giving statues to the money. Anyway.
But we also give them, you know, like how gaudy and big Super Bowl rings are?
Yes.
Bubba does Bubba Army royalty rings that he gives
dog
out.
Dog tags, let's do it.
See, this motherfucker does it right. You won't even let me.
Let's do it.
Oh, I'm back in, baby.
I've been trying to do a plastic fucking card.
You have.
For 20 years.
Yeah, you have.
The fucking business of ours like, no fucking plastic cards. Have you priced those motherfuckers?
And he's like, it's just more plastic shit.
And Bubba the Love Sponge is giving away goddamn Brady rings. A goddamn
Super
Bowl.
them. You have to buy them.
How much are they?
You
Tux?
Wanted to give a card like to every BDM. I was like, it's going to cost us.
It'll bankrupt the company.
$4,000 just to mail anything.
Oh, mailing would be bad. It'd be really bad.
No, but I mean, a lot of the people come to the party, and the party is.
Is Jenny Jizz there? Is Jenny Jizz there giving blowjobs to the troops or something? Like, do you guys do all the crazy stuff?
We have only been like talking to Naughty Alicia. Jenny Jizz is kind of taking a little bit of a time out after Super Blow 50 that we did
Super Blow 50
years.
Exactly. Got HPV in the throat. She's out of the game.
Come on, don't say that.
Allegedly out of the game. It hurts when I'm eating ice cream.
So basically we have it's a two-pronged system where anybody can come out to the Davenport Ale House.
Sorry.
I love you, Tux. I love you so much.
Listen,
I love a zinger sound.
You know you're not supposed to call it that anymore, and I'm not bullshitting you. I was told by a person that worked there, they're like, we're phasing that out. We like to call it Miller's.
Miller's
and not, they're phasing Ale House out.
Like if you go to anybody Maisie's age and above, like any young kid, like
call it Miller's?
A teen. Yeah, if you go like, we'll go to Ale House, the teens
are not
like,
getting sued.
No, they're like, fuck you, old man. It's Miller. They don't call it Ale House. They call it Miller's.
Oh, well, that's ridiculous.
I know.
Miller's.
I know.
That doesn't sound good. It's Ale House.
I know. I said the same thing. And then they're going heavy on the, you know, the little caricature of the little fishing ragdoll.
Yeah. Okay.
Does anybody know what I'm talking about?
No, I don't.
There's a mascot.
Yeah, I did not know there was a mascot.
There's a mascot at Miller's Ale House, and it's like a little
never paid attention
hand drawn ragdoll boy who's like fishing.
Okay.
And they're going heavy on the ragdoll.
Okay. All
right. Miller's ragdoll.
They want to merchandise that.
Yeah, you heard it here first.
Yeah.
So we're doing that on the 16th. That is at 6 o'clock p.m. We're not drinking at 6 o'clock in the morning. But we're gonna have
out the whole ale house?
Well, no, we have our own like little like section.
You have a table.
I got you.
We've done that.
We got the whole outside because we
got the game room in the back.
You have a table. You know, yeah.
We have to put up the cash cube.
Yeah, yeah.
Whoa. No,
I am jealous of this.
Okay, hold on a
second.
I've always wanted to do this.
Is this coming from a sponsor?
Yeah, it is. Yes.
All right, that's why. Yeah. What sponsor?
Mm-hmm. Oh, I hope it's like Truck Nuts or Mega Horns.
I think it is Diaco Law Firm has donated the money.
Your lunatic law partner?
Diaco. How do you spell Diaco?
Don't you guys have a crazy lawyer?
We already got Mo. You can't put Diaco.
Well, I'm in Mo's Money House.
There you go. Mo's Money Cube.
Yeah, yeah, that's Mo's good. Money Cube. Yeah, that's even
really
better.
Good.
Yeah,
that's really
you
good.
Got the goods. Oh, so yeah. Much.
I'm higher. Back in.
Oh, my God. I'm going to dress as a manatee with a bloody butthole. We running around.
That's the new Halloween costume.
Yeah, I'm like a manatee. And there's blood.
Oh, then I'll be the manatee with the bloody dick.
Yeah, you're fucking me. And they're shooting fruit at my butt.
Sorry.
But we did a lot of R&D when it comes to the cash cube.
Oh, yeah, sure you did.
Uh-huh. You know, other interns and stuff, because Bubba wanted to kind of get an idea of how much money, like, somebody could get. Like, we started off at 30 seconds, and then it was like, oh, that's too much money. Maybe we need to go to 15. You can't trap the money up against the wall.
That's a trick. I've seen it on TikTok. Yeah, a guy gets in there and then he stands up against the wall and then all the money just piles up in his shirt. Like,
yeah.
Or he lifts
his shirt up.
Oh, he does like a sale.
And then he put like one arm out to funnel and it was like, and all the money just goes right in and you got a belly full of money. Like, look at me.
But this will be, I think, maybe the fourth attempt of us trying to debut the cash cube, because every event that we've tried to do, we've had monsoons roll in.
Right.
And the cash cube had to be postponed on three separate occasions.
All right.
So this will be the debut of the cash cube.
Awesome. Right,
so
I love it.
Cash cube.
What other, like, I heard that you also are trying to beat a squirting record.
That might be at the content house.
Okay, all right.
Not
at the ale house, sorry. Not at Miller's. Not at Miller's.
No. But there are a lot of stunts, and this is what I need to ask Please don't get offended when I say this, because I'm asking advice of a stuntman, and this is why I'm saying drunkie and not Tom.
Honestly, like, if you land your helicopter in the backyard of a former paramilitary guy, mm-hmm. you don't walk up to him and call him John. You call him fucking Rambo, right?
Yeah. So, drunkie, I need to bring at least two stunts to the content.
Oh, you don't even have stunts yet?
No, I mean, I do, but I would like to collaborate with one of the best.
I got it.
You're a big manager now. You got a day job. Like, it's crazy that you're even, like kind of dipping your toe back into stunting.
I've got your stunt. Are you listening, okay. Tuttle?
Okay. That was fast.
You know, some magicians recreate or try to do the same stunt that killed another magician.
Take your Advil.
And so it's like the stunt that ended up hurting Houdini, other
the water?
Magicians. Yeah, they do that, you know, the milk can water stunt. I think that was
the one that got him?
There's been deadly magic stunts.
I thought it was the cannonball in the stomach.
No, I thought it was
someone punched his
he did the punching thing.
Anyway, so my point is, you have to recreate the most dangerous or one of the most dangerous stunts ever been to be done by a radio stuntman.
Burying concrete again?
No. It's get pulled by your balls by a lark and rollerblades.
But you let Whopper Jr. drive the lark this time.
To one-up it. It can't be the exact same.
He's mad that I even brought it up.
Yeah, I know.
So what if you pull him?
He wants nothing to do with none of this.
What if you pull him on your one wheel?
That's not bad. What if we let Cabin Boy Matt from Gabe Tilbury?
Dress up as drunkie. Drunkie pulls Tuttle by the balls on a one wheel.
We let Cabin Boy Matt, formerly judge of Gabe Tilbury.
No, he said never mention that.
Drive the Lord.
No, he said he'll never do anything like that.
Okay, let's let John the Alarm Guy or the pedophile wrestler we almost hired for our 9-year anniversary.
Anyway, that's the stunt, Tuttle, because it's infamous.
But it's been done.
Not
successfully.
Not successfully.
Well, what's the success?
He'd have to do it with no injury.
Yes, you have to get pulled without.
I don't know that that's possible.
Eliminating.
Yeah. You know what? The way to do it is to just be pulled by your penis, not by your balls.
Oh, my penis. I used to hang 2-liter bottles of Czech soda off of the head.
What? Like you're stretching your ears?
No, I did. I did that because I couldn't, it was before the internet and I couldn't order a penis pump. So
that's how you got such a big dick?
He used to hang Winn-Dixie brand Czech cola from it.
I would lift it, so I would put a paper towel around the foreskin, and then I would loop shoelaces around the thing so I didn't get rope burn on my foreskin. And I would do 3 sets of 20.
No, this guy's lying. I was like, "Where's this going?"
He don't like to have fun anymore. No. He's like, "Oh, this motherfucker's lying." Now that manatee story, that shit was real. But
he was taking notes because he wanted to make his dick bigger.
Yeah, he got motion in you. I was like, "Why you put your pencil down?" You got mad.
I was like, "Why is this guy doing this to himself? Is it a stunt?" I was trying to figure out where it's going. He's just saying some nonsense.
That's what I do.
No, it's not. My mom and dad used to go pick up. Payroll from Addison Steel in Orlando. And while they were gone, it was just jack session.
You had a couple
for 3 hours.
Hours
they were gone, and I decided to stretch it out.
No.
I believe he did it at least once.
Nobody says it that calm and then not done
it. He definitely did it at least once.
Well, that motherfucker just drew you a map to the treasure.
Why'd you do that?
See what would happen. He was a boy. Boys are dumb.
He's also had a big dick. Like, I look at my dick and I'm embarrassed of it. I don't look at it and be like, oh, you know what? Let's do some fun with this thing.
Do you think you could hold 2 Czech colas?
No, but he did think he could carry. One time when we started this fucking show, this dum-dum thought he could carry a 6-pack of beer on his boner. And that's an impossibility.
All we do is look down, or we could press it like an elevator button. That's all.
He's got a little bit of scar tissueing that has Peyronie's right at the thing.
Okay.
What else are you guys doing in okay, once you get to the content house, what are you in charge of other than stunts?
I'm boxing people.
You're boxing people.
Especially some of the women, but also my best friend Colton. I'm boxing him.
Oh, Colton's going to knock you? Well, you're a good boxer.
I have to sleep in a tent. I'm not allowed to sleep in the content house on the front yard.
All right.
I have a tent.
So why do you gotta sleep in the tent?
because not enough rooms, and I guess they want me to like kind of run a little security type deal.
Your security?
Let Bubba.
Sam, you don't understand.
What the hell?
He's got to sleep in a tent for the whole thing to work.
Yeah, it kind of is. It's the only thing that needs to happen is the tent. Or you could beg Bubba to let you sleep in the shit shack.
It starts to drive him crazy, and then the crazier the better.
Well, Colton's gonna go in the middle of the night and put like I don't know M80 under his tent and blow up the tent, a fucking hole in it, right?
I also am getting glass marbles shot at my ass with a wrist rocket.
That got me.
There's Tom's joy.
I played him. I played him a clip yesterday from like some old 90s radio, and this motherfucker he busted out. I'm like, I found your joy. I found his fucking joy.
So why are they shooting your ass with marbles? I mean, that's gonna.
Why not?
You know those Nerf dart guns that you get?
Yeah.
Like, they're one to see if they could actually get one inserted into my anus from 5 feet away.
Oh, they're going for the hole.
Yeah, they're going for the hole, not the cheek.
Have you thought about, like, not... Now, hey, if you really want to do that, I'll give you a tip on that one. If you go if you go to like Ace or something and just get yourself a regular medium piece of PVC that's only about that big and you lube it and put it in your butthole, they'll be able to shoot and it'll bounce off your stomach on the inside. Straight in. It just go whoop. It's just like right in there.
I've been having, thank God, not doing this week. I've had some really, I must have ate something really bad.
Okay.
I've got green diarrhea.
This is the worst show we've ever done.
Why did you even mention that? So, Tuttle.
You were talking about my anus, and I just think if you put a PVC pipe in there, you would have green shit coming out.
Let me ask you.
Oh, God.
Did he leave?
No. There's out of that. I'm going to throw up.
So, Tuttle.
It's the lunch hour.
I know. I'm sorry.
So when does it, like, you're on air from when to when?
Yeah. Is this 24 morning hours?
Show? Is this morning?
No, I said 6 p.m. We're going to do it overnight, and then we're going to move on to our next most downloadable city.
And do it again. So it's kind of like a tour.
Yes.
So you're going to be doing
this was a stationary, for days.
Well, no, he will be there for a couple days, but you're going to be doing multiple marble anus in different cities.
In different areas. And I think it's a great idea because Bubba does make sure that he takes care of the very, very important listeners. I mean, he loves all the listeners, but you got to show extra love to the ones that
want to put marbles in your ass.
On.
Yeah, I agree.
So are you coming to a city near me?
He's coming to Orlando. Are you going to shoot some marbles?
What's it like at a Tuttle Butthole marble show? What's it like?
What I think would be good, and I need to run this by them, but I think if the Tom and Dan show came out to the Content House.
Yes.
This is the part I didn't tell you because I knew you wouldn't go for it.
And did it brought you guys are you're the host. You make me do what radio stunt? So yeah. I am your stunt boy.
Yeah.
No, I respect you too much.
What if we dress like, I can't
look at you in the eye and shoot a marble in your butthole.
What if you have to look him in the eye for that?
Let me ask you something.
Can't do
Let
that.
Let me ask you something. What if we dress as big and little manatees and we go to the content house and we go to the content house and we shoot darts in his anus?
No. This will go viral.
It will go viral.
No, I know.
All we have
to
do is dress like manatees.
You wanted to have fun, joy.
I'm just gonna order two simple manatee costumes. Mm-hmm. From Amazon, no. Big and Little Manatee.
God,
we'll shoot a couple of darts into his ass and call it a day. We'll be in and out in 20 minutes.
They want it, but it's like Sam. It's like Sam. You know, it's like you can't do the goddamn OnlyFans because you're like, I can't do it. I can't do this.
Well, what who really, said I can't
it's
do it?
Gonna look weird. Well, do you want to dress as a manatee? Anyone?
You know, like I just can't. Bring myself.
Tuttle,
don't you want to be a legend, Tom?
I want Tuttle to be a legend, though.
The idea of it. He loves the idea.
You could be the one to get the marble in.
I don't want
to. 90s. But when it comes down to it, you will puss out.
I know. I admit it.
Yeah. All right, you heard it here. Yeah. Listen, Tom admits he's a pussy. I said that on the Delta 9 show, and everyone got mad.
That's true. I forgot about that.
I can't, let someone shoot marbles into a bowl.
Not yours.
We're not going to shoot them.
And I can't shoot marbles into anybody else's bottle.
The marbles are for my ass cheeks. The Nerf gun bullets are for my butt.
Does that change anything?
No, it's still kind of okay. The same. Right. It's more of just the idea of it all. And then I'm just like, what is that?
What if you were just there and I did it?
Yeah.
Because I have no problem shooting anything into his asshole. I'm your guy.
Well, then the picture.
What's that movie? I'm Last Sniper or whatever? I'm that guy. Bradley Cooper.
Bradley Cooper. You're Bradley American Cooper. Sniper.
I'm literally going to shoot a dart into your butthole, and then I'm going to go to a gun range and kill myself.
Oh, my God. Legend.
I'm going to shoot you in the back of the head before he eats a bullet.
Stop.
Jesus.
Stop.
I think our listeners and then our sponsors, they're going to be like, I didn't
think about that. You're right. I didn't think of the sponsors. I didn't think of them at all.
What are you doing?
What if they want it though? What if I could get two? Yeah, call Mo. Call Mo right now.
Have Lil Mo shoot the marbles.
Will Mo dress as a manatee?
Mo does like to dress up.
Dan and Mo the manatee.
No. Don't bring him into this. He told me that. Don't bring me into the ship.
We got another call. Should I take it?
Yeah. Party line.
Okay, hold on. Thank you for calling Tom and Dan. Who's this?
Is the butt fucking manatee?
Is this Butler?
Is this Travis Butler?
No, it's the butt fucking manatee.
Oh, the manatee man?
Is this DeBerry Jones?
Yeah, I have a quick story for you. So I'm in San Diego. I have a friend who
trains. Manatee man, listening to the show? You're like, I'm gonna call right now.
I think that's a different guy.
Is it a different guy?
It might be a different guy.
What did he say?
He wanted to tell us a story real quick.
He said, this is butt fucking manatee.
He was giving a call back. It was a joke.
I didn't butt fuck a manatee. I'm the guy he called about. Anyway.
So you are easy. Oh, it is.
Yeah, you're the same guy. Hold on a second. We're talking to Tuttle. Are you listening to the show?
I was, but...
I lost interest.
I stopped after my call about butt fucking manatees.
And then I thought of something that would be great, and so I said, fuck it, I'll go.
This is better than Tuttle.
I'll call it and make their show better.
Hold on, so you were listening to the show. You called in, and we talked to you for a long time. You proved me wrong, which doesn't happen that often.
Well, that's debatable.
It was immediate prove wrong. It was like I was saying bullshit, and immediately I got proved wrong, so I had to fucking eat it. I was like, you know what? You should change your ways. This guy proved you wrong. And then you lost interest in the show?
Do you know what a pink shark is?
God damn it.
I hate this guy. I love him and I hate him.
And so you called the show and then you hung up and you're like, that's about enough.
I got more marine biology facts for them.
What's a pink
shark?
Yeah. Pink shark. So there's a Naval Dolphin Training Center out here. And sometimes the dolphins get a little, like kind of like the manatees, they get a little fishy.
Yeah, they're rapey, yeah.
And they
we know
swim.
That.
Of course
I mean,
you know it.
Why are you calling in and telling us, like, obvious things, you son of a bitch? Like, these guys will barely ever have me on the show, and I don't need some goddamn asshole from San Diego calling in and taking away from my time here. Like, I'm not trying to be some egotistical fucking asshole or anything, but, man, back the fuck off here and hang up.
Hey, Tuttle, come to San Diego. You got a place to stay, man. I love you, man.
Oh, wow.
He's a pussy like Tom.
He's a pink shark.
Yeah, nobody wants to shoot anything. Nobody wants to shoot anything into a butthole right
now.
Everybody's hugging each other.
I'm sorry.
Hey, I'm sorry. I'll come stay in my fucking house.
I'm too good to shoot a marble in a butthole.
I don't suck your dick, bro.
I can't say no fast enough.
I love you, dude. I love you, brother.
Yeah, I'll do anything for my family, but I should do this, right?
Yeah, you should, because you would be rich and famous.
This is for my family.
Yeah.
This will benefit
them. You can justify it that way.
Yeah. Like, people will watch it. I think they'll pay me money to do it.
Yeah.
I think you as a businessman, should take this opportunity to be a part of this event, Tom. You might be able to get some brand new ideas from Bubba about, you know, how you're supposed to treat your listeners and make them feel like they're everything to you and the whole entire world.
Yeah.
Well, last time I saw Bubba, he gave me a marijuana gummy that literally blew my shorts off.
That was Star of Death.
Yeah, it was a Star of Death.
Yeah.
I wouldn't take something gold Star of Death.
Well, I won't again.
Learned your lesson.
Yeah, it was the last time I'll do it.
And if you're talking about the business model of befriending the listeners that give you the most amount of money, I've already done that.
I'm
trying to do it.
We're trying our hardest currently.
You're not making bronze bust of the listeners.
No, we're not. I wrote it down.
We're not. We did write it down.
So my last thing to you, Tuttle, is after all this, and when does it start again, by the way?
November 16th.
6 p.m.
It's weird having someone that listens to the show in here. It's because Sam knew that. I had no idea.
And I can watch it.
Watching this.
I think you could just search it on YouTube. What do I do here?
Yeah.
Do you guys miss Sam?
Yeah, of course.
Yeah, of course we do.
Okay.
They have to say that, right?
I mean, we are obligated to say that.
I'm sitting right here.
What am I saying?
No, fuck that bitch. I'm glad she left. Saved us some money.
You traded Sam for Ross, and I'm just like,
No, we really.
There's just no one now.
Now we're just stressed out all this fucking time and fighting with each other.
But yeah, no.
Where can we watch it, Tuttle?
YouTube, Twitch.
Where can we watch it? Where can we stream it?
It will be Bubba, like, he does not discriminate against streaming platforms. It'll be on YouTube, Twitch,
so just look
Rumble.
For Bubba the Love Sponges channel.
Yeah, just search at The Bubba Army. Bubba Army.
Oh, okay.
Awesome.
So I do really think this, Tuttle, where you can become the most legendary radio stunt guy of all time. I mean, because I imagine if we look at everybody in the world,
no one's still doing it.
Anybody who's doing it in the 90s isn't currently doing it.
The only one that even came close to you was Flipper. Do you remember Flipper?
Oh, yeah, from Ron and Ron.
Yeah, he was the only one that would have ever come close to you, and you've far surpassed.
Paulo was the other one.
You're still in the game, is my point. Like, everyone else is out.
Yes.
You are literally the last guy that I know of. Now, there have been new guys that have come back in, or new guys that start doing it.
Oh, yeah,
But no legacy guys that did it, like, top-tier 90s, 2000s, and now the 2020s, you know, 2010s.
Do you realize how big it would be if we did an event where it was one final ride? You know how Kiss always say that it's their retirement show? I have no plans on retiring. But me, you, Drunky the Bear, and Whopper Jr.
One last ride.
Yeah.
You know what it's like?
Well, I know.
Oh my God,
it's like the movie
Wild Hogs.
Yeah.
You got to get chunks in there, too.
I'll be looking at chunks. The numbers, but I'm 50-50. There's a 99% chance that Whopper Jr. is not showing up.
I don't think he'd ever take the call.
I have that picture saved on my phone. It's actually my wallpaper of him getting his large stretch.
That's kind of
Tuttle,
creepy.
The problem is with doing this, eventually, and I'm not saying that I hope this is soon or this is even in the next 20 years.
Yeah, your anus loses its elasticity.
No. Yeah.
You get a falled out anus.
Well, eventually there's no more show to do stunts on. So
there'll always be a show.
The internet exists, man.
TikTok. You get on TikTok and start shooting them darts.
Yeah. But Tuttle knows how hard the internet show game is. It's nearly impossible. What I'm saying is...
I'll be on bum fights, living under an overpass.
The only way to truly legitimize your legendary status is to die doing one of these stunts.
Yeah. You have to be big dick nerd Gigi Allen.
Once you die doing a stunt that's completely insane, then that's where it's like, oh my God, this guy, and then your whole life.
But what stunt would you want to die doing?
Russian roulette?
No.
You know what you could do?
It's got to be like you're getting shot off into a rocket.
So we never see the body again.
Yes.
Shoot yourself into that Maitland building.
Oh, that'd be good.
He's done a lot.
I can't. I can't actually go. I'm trespassed from the
Magisterium. Oh, you're going to be dead. Who gives a fuck?
What about that pod? What about that Swedish death pod that you can get in that they just put in the woods and you hit a button and it gasses you dead?
No.
The death bag. I know how to do the at-home ones. I've researched it.
It's got
to
be.
This is a morbid show today. We've gone deep. There's morbid. There's
manatee
a lot of weird.
Death. No,
but it's not negative.
I think Tom is talking Tuttle into killing
it's
himself.
It's not.
No,
which he's already tried, by the way.
That was like Evel Knievel. Like he would be more of a legend if he would have like crashed into the other side of the canyon.
Yeah. Now he just kind of faded out like a racist old man with a cane.
Yes. And then no one ever at the end. It was just like.
But still, people still remember him.
Yeah, but you just but they remember the racist old man. They don't remember the legend of Knievel.
Yeah, it's like it's like even the moon landing. We remember John Glenn yelling at people for not believing it more than we remember the moon landing.
If he would have gone in that rocket, then he would be 10 times more of a legend.
The Snake
Canyon. If he never survived, if that parachute didn't come out, he just crashed it. Like he'd be insane.
What's your greatest stunt, Tuds? Before we get out of here, what do you think is your greatest?
Buried Alive, maybe.
That was a height.
Not sure, but like you guys are all talking about this. At what age does embarrassing shit like stop happening to you?
42. Tom, you heard of him, Tom. He's
done. No. It's just I don't see.
It's different for everybody, I think.
It is different for everybody, and I don't.
I went to a wrong funeral the other day, and it was about 3/4 of the way through before I found out that I was at the wrong funeral.
It's the thought that counts. It is the thought that counts. You know what? Did you commit or did you get up and leave?
I got up.
No.
Between like
you
got to
commit. You commit to it even if you're missing the other one. And if anybody asks, you're like, well, I was there in spirit because you were doing you were doing what you needed to do.
You were in mourning.
I was a week early. It's actually tomorrow. I went to Alan Summerhill like funeral home right there in DeLand for my guidance counselor's funeral. And I went in the side door.
This nerd will never amount to nothing.
Wait a minute. Your high school guidance counselor?
I'll show you. I'll be at your funeral. I'll be at your funeral now. I'll spit on your grave.
This big
didn't go to her funeral, though.
God damn it.
What the hell's going on?
I'm sorry, Tuttle. Why'd you tell us this?
I sat in the back row, and I'm looking around, and I'm like, man.
Fuck you, Mr. Kerbobble.
I didn't realize that I had went to school with so many dark people at the time.
Oh, I gotta go. I gotta get out of here.
Yeah, you probably should. Run for your car. Run for your car.
I heard things that just have
that.
Taken a turn.
Dodge's phrases. Dodge's phrases.
Oh, my God. Our ratings just spiked. This is what they wanted all along.
This is
what
they
wanted. What is it? That's not politically correct. Like, I'm as pale as it can be, and I'm just trying to say, I just assumed these were all the kids that played basketball for.
Would anybody like to get up and say anything about Mr. Thompson?
I have something I'd like to say. This motherfucker said I'd never amount to nothing, and now I'm on Bubba the Love Sponge shooting darts into my asshole. So take that.
Never retired.
I signed the book with my first and last name, too. So I'm sure at the end, when they're reading the book and everything, they're going to be like, who the fuck is Patrick Fowler?
And then one old man in the back is like, I know the legend of Fowler.
I know who he is. And then they turn that man's got the biggest anus in Volusia County.
Hey, you talking about the Fowler that blew up his anus in the legendary bomb stunt?
You're talking about old blown out anus. Blown out anus Fowler.
He blew himself in half. Blew his anus here to DeBerry.
They say sometimes late at night in Volusia County, if you just catch the wind right, you can hear the wind whistling through his anus.
Listen, guys, I don't have a loose asshole. I do male Kegels every morning.
Okay? We're going to let you go. We love you.
Male Kegels. You guys don't do male Kegels?
No, I don't do nothing. I'm a man. I drink Coors Light in the afternoon. I watch sports.
All right. Tuttle, I'm going to be watching. I want to see. I want to talk to you after.
Tell Bubba we're all on board. I'll get him on. I'll work on him.
Reach back out when it's closer because it's November.
I got Sam. Sam's good. Me and you, we're tight. We'll work on this guy.
We'll go to Miller's.
I'll see you in Miller's.
Yeah.
Bear soup?
Okay.
I'll work on it. Cool.
You even still have one?
He does. I'll work on it. I love you, buddy. Be good.
All right, bye.
All right, see you.
Tommy wants to be Drunky the Bear for Halloween this
year. Okay. Why would you not let that happen?
Yeah, of course.
I'm happy. Good. But Crystal is like,
wash that
don't,
thing.
Yeah, you gotta put your foot down.
She's like, no one's gonna know what that is.
And well, you'll know.
Bear in the Big Blue House.
That's where you explain.
You'll know.
And then I'm like, some dads will know.
Yeah, they will.
Yeah, they will.
Like,
I will bet my life you'll get at least one.
One in my neighborhood that will know. One.
Yeah, Castle Perry knows. Castle Perry knows.
We're in the right place, son.
100%.
We may have to go to a different location.
You don't have to know every single costume, right?
Yeah.
I do kind of hate the kids that dress up as like really rare things. It's kind of you're not gonna have a good experience.
Well, how many goddamn Spider-Mans do you need?
I know. You're right.
But at least Daniel is kind of right where if you don't know at
obscure.
All, if
I don't
it's
ask
so
anymore.
Obscure,
and I know that's a dickhead thing to do, but when little girls and little boys walk up to my house,
you don't need that.
I used to ask. I'd be like, "Oh, what are you?" And then they'd explain it. Now I don't even ask. I don't give a fuck.
Too much information.
Yeah, just take some toys.
Like, we don't give, here's some candy.
We don't give candy anymore. Andrea buys Chinese plastic.
Although you don't give out candy?
No, we give out little erasers, fidgets, squishables, smushables, smashables, squishes.
I almost
all kids are on the spectrum now, and they all need little toys to play with their
sensory
hands.
Yeah,
yeah. Every kid has a whole
stimming
pocket full
toys.
Of just little things and
love
trinkets.
It.
My sons do like those toys. I think we've talked about this before. When they get those little,
because we don't have attention spans, we got to be doing something at all times.
We get the little plastic garbage. They are like, ooh,
You
know, because in a sea of candy, that stands out.
Yeah.
So I will agree that
they love it.
The kids do like
that. They love it so much.
Yeah. All right, let's take a break.
Yes.
When we come back, I want to talk to Sam about
a
bunch
Millers.
Of things. Yeah. Well, I need to know what's going on in the world. And
I think Sam can bring you up to speed.
Well, you gave me one assignment, and then you switched it up a couple days later because it got too dark.
Well, I didn't know the whole story, and then I was like, let me see what's funny about this.
We started
another funny.
We read a lot of Diddy stuff, and then Tom from the other room said to me, he's like, yeah, this is, are you reading what I'm reading? I'm like, yeah. Where it's real bad. This is not fun. Not even remotely entertaining.
I'm like, any angle that I found almost sounds like I'm defending.
Are people doing that though.
Those are Toms that didn't read the fucking story before. They're just going off the cuff.
Yeah.
Then you're like, well, we're gonna go.
They
with
just
this.
Hear freak off and they're like, hey, who cares? You're a little freaky, who cares?
Yeah.
That's what I said.
I knew it.
Like, freak off.
He did.
Everybody
exact
off.
Phrase was a little freak off hurt nobody.
A thousand baby oil. All right, who cares?
All right,
who can? Then I read more.
Then he said, you hear about this. 1,000 bottles of baby oil from Costco, and then I go, it's a boom, not a doom. Sorry, that's the Costco guys.
All right, let's take a break.
Here is your break. Brand new music from The Last Gang. This band rocks. Female fronted, pretty damn heavy, really fun. After that, you're going to get Almost Monday. We'll be right back with more A Mediocre Time with Tom and Dan.
Yeah.
Sounds just like Tame Impala. Not Tame Impala. Just Google it. I don't want to tell you. Welcome back to A Mediocre Time with Tom and Dan. I'm Dan.
I'm Tom.
Samantha's here.
Yep. Also, if we're doing a BDM Oktoberfest style event, October 19th.
Yeah, man.
And we'll send out the invite.
At the Millers.
The Millers at Davenport.
Millers.
We got three booths.
Yeah.
I came out of pocket.
Get
two booths.
Get there early. Get locked out.
We will
out.
Be sharing a, what was that thing we used to get? A mountain melt.
Holy shit.
Do they still have those or are they healthy now?
They got them. They got the mountain.
Is it a smaller mountain though now?
Like every place now that you used to go and get that shit, like all the, everything's healthy now. Like you go places, they're like, we can't do this anymore. This is terrible.
Now they did tell us we all have to be there at the same time before they'll see us.
That's
so
correct.
So
yeah.
Please show up on time.
Full party,
Okay. So Sam, what is going on?
So originally you guys did want me to do some of the Diddy stuff, which I have some of that information.
So,
but I think you know everybody kind of knows.
A freak party's a freak party.
Ain't no party like a freak off party.
He's
you know, the 1,000 bottles of lubricant and baby oil. His lawyer said it came from Costco because Costco is close to his mansions. Costco made a statement and said, that is not true. We don't even sell that at our store.
That's actually something we can talk about, is that Costco did come out.
Isn't
and
that
like,
hilarious?
Costco's like,
no, they
dog.
Felt the need to be like, no, no, no.
They're distancing themselves
we
from
We did
Diddy.
Not sell
yeah.
Diddy a yeah. thousand bottles.
I saw that statement where the lawyer's like, Costco's right near his house. Yeah. He buys in
Why
bulk.
Why would he even say that?
Like, wouldn't you check?
His lawyer, I'm sorry, is saying some really dumb shit right now.
Yeah, he reminds me of
Shut
that.
Shut the hell up.
He reminds me of that Seinfeld lawyer. Like, yes. I forget that guy, that character, but he's so good.
There is a there's a bumbling lawyer
Johnny.
Element where I've seen bumbling lawyers
you
like
had one. I've had a great one.
I've seen them bumble themselves into victory.
Yeah.
I swear to God. I think Jose
Casey Anthony's, Jose Baez.
Jose Baez bumbled himself
right
to a win.
And then I watched him.
And then we watched him win. Yeah. And it's like this bumbling fool won.
And he won.
Every once in a while they win.
And he won multiple times. Like, I don't think that was the only time he won. I think Jose Baez, for all intents and purposes, like, you can look at that dude and he like fairly successful attorney.
I think it confuses the jury because they're like, this guy's bumbling around.
He's
like,
so dumb and his suit's so baggy.
It makes you feel bad. You're
it's
like,
we're just like him scenario.
It's called the jelly roll. That's the jelly roll, right?
Yeah. This guy reminds me of my eating habits.
Wait a second.
If he can do it, I can do it, right?
I want to watch him act next to Sylvester Stallone.
Do you want to see that? Should we play that now? Can I play that now? I don't want to interrupt your thing, but I've got it here. Okay, hold on. I have to show this to you. This is the acting debut of the everyone's favorite country music superstar, Jelly Roll. This is his acting debut on the hit Paramount Plus show, Tulsa King, starring Sylvester Stallone. Here we go.
How you doing, Grace?
You gotta see this.
See what? What's the guy's name again?
I've told you a million times, it's Jelly Roll.
Jelly Roll? I never heard of him.
Jelly Roll. Jelly Roll.
What's the problem? Oh, there's no problem. Oh.
There's Jelly. There he is.
Oh, hey, how you doing?
Man, I'm doing great. How are you?
You're Jellyfish, right?
You're close. It's Jelly Roll.
You're Jellyfish,
okay,
right?
This is giving me deja vu.
This is good. Hey, you're Jellyfish, right?
Not long ago, I watched Uncut Gems.
Okay, yeah.
And in that movie...
I have an Uncut Gem.
In that movie, there is a scene where they are talking about The Weeknd, and they keep saying over and over. Notice how they kept saying over and over, Jelly Roll, Jelly Roll, Jelly Roll, trying to get that name in your head. That scene with The Weeknd, I'm like, what is this, a commercial for The Weeknd?
Oh, he's in.
And then he was like, the Super Bowl the next year.
Do you think it was planted on purpose?
You know how they do marketing now where instead of like blurring out a Coke, now the branding of the Coke is in? I feel like this is marketing.
Yeah, he's everywhere. In Chip Crazy. In the last
making
episode,
a joke Jellyfish just to say Jelly Roll one more time
in the show Chimp Crazy, the last episode, like one of the most poignant moments, like I'm not going to give it away, but the lead character Tanya is
that
looking
should be her for Halloween.
She looks at that's actually
I
pretty funny
got the hair.
You could put the monkey around your you could put like a monkey around your okay but
she
looks,
was doing something with that monkey, right?
She looks at her well I think a lot of those
he was doing this.
What could she have done with
the
it
monkey no. people no a lot
give
of the monkey
them,
people
no
yes he not. Was they kept showing him
a lot
that.
Of the
Hold
monkey
was doing to her.
After watching the
How
whole,
do you have,
I've
make
watched.
Them do that?
I've watched all of them. I think these monkey people have
give
the monkeys suck their dicks.
And, he loves Gatorade.
I think they have sex with their monkeys.
You didn't watch this?
I think they do. They're obsessed with them, dude. They say they love them more than their own families and their own children.
We turned it on, and Chris was like, "I can't watch this. So not good."
Did you watch Tiger King?
Yes,
it's the same guy.
It's the same shit.
She has some more affinity towards monkeys than tigers. I don't know why.
I do too.
She was able to watch the
tigers. They're more like us. They're more like us.
But she feels bad about the monkeys.
Yeah, but Jelly Roll, like back to that, like I don't even know where I was going with that. Oh no, in the episode.
Yes.
Tanya looks at the radio and then she starts singing a Jelly Roll song. And then they put his name and then like the radio says like Jelly Roll, I am not okay, or Jelly Roll, some song
right,
in his album.
Whatever the song
and
was.
It's getting showcased and you can hear it and she's singing along with it. And I look at Andrew, I go, this motherfucker is everywhere. He's on The Voice, American Idol, America's Got Talent. Every award show. He's singing, he's performing, he's on Howard Stern, he's been on our fucking show. Mm-hmm. How has he been
Well, he was on our show way
before he got famous. Before
he but it's just weird. He's everywhere.
So is there a possibility he signed some deal with a major...
With the devil.
He's getting pushed hard.
Record label, yeah. And then part of that deal is they make money off of his success as well.
I'm sure.
So they're integrating him in all these different shows they can.
But it's weird.
You know, yeah, it is. But it makes more sense if he has a deal where some other giant corporation is making... part of his money.
It also, like, he's appearing on songs that, like, are just straight trash, like the Lonely Road song with MGK and Jelly Roll, where they sample John Denver's Country Roads Take Me Home.
Oh,
it is
God.
Trash. It is the worst song of the year, and he's on the song. It's crazy.
They're just pushing him. I don't think they'd push him if they didn't have a cut. They have to have a cut, right? He's not making all the money.
And you do think everybody loves him because we all look at him. And because, I mean, like, if you take Jelly Roll's persona and you shoot it into any other body, does it work?
No.
I don't know if it works. He's a perfect storm.
I don't want to say that.
He's
because
the big perfect storm.
I feel like it's taking something away from him. You know, like people used to say, like, the only reason you're successful is the bear suit.
All right. Okay, great. This is great. You can speak from, you can give us from
people,
your perspective.
I mean, Sam and her friends. But I'm just saying,
you found my Reddit page.
So if you, like, say, like, the only reason you're successful is because of how big you are, I feel like it's an insult.
I don't think it's the only reason.
No,
think it's an angle.
He's super
that
nice.
They are using.
He's super kind. One of the nicest.
And I personally have a theory that wasn't he like starting to run marathons and stuff?
Oh yeah, he's been working out.
I personally have a theory that he's going to trim down.
And then we won't like him.
Maybe
though.
On the low key, Ozempic style, but we won't know that, right? We'll get the narrative that he got healthy.
Yeah.
And
but then we won't like him anymore.
Just like Post Malone, and everybody shit on Post Malone when he got sober and healthy and slimmed down.
Yeah, but
now he's a country star.
He slimmed down, like, for Jelly Roll to get to, like, what? I mean, how tall is he? 10, 11?
No, he was at least 6.
He's probably 6'1", 6'1".
6'1", he should weigh, like, what, 250 is a normal 6'1 dude or whatever. And then it's like...
I think it's gay to think about.
What are you, Jerry Jones over here giving us his measurements?
I fucking love that. I was trying to figure out how to make that. I was trying to make that.
Nobody was talking about that.
We talked about it. I wanted to make it my lock charm on my fucking Tesla.
Jamie Foxx was like, end.
I wanted my car when it locks to be like 8.5-inch dick.
Yeah.
That yellow tooth bastard.
Right, sorry, we're getting distracted.
Sorry.
Sam,
oh, this is fun.
Back to what's going on.
We're trying
on.
To have fun on this show.
Yeah, we're having a fun Friday. This has been a fun Friday.
Get us back on track. Yeah. Sam, type some stuff out. What are you hearing?
Yeah.
What do we got here?
Oh, do you want to go back to the Diddy stuff?
Yeah.
Quickly, like I was saying, his lawyer is saying crazy stuff. His lawyer is saying that Diddy is going to take the stand, which... to me, sounds like a bad move, but...
Yeah, traditionally, don't lawyers tell the...
dumb people to not take the stand? Yeah, and he's a dumb person.
And he's a narcissist.
Have you ever heard him talk? He's dumb.
Yeah.
The convicted whatever, the lawyer's like, how about you just sit right here, right? They don't want him, like, we don't need to get you talking.
No.
If we can avoid it, let's not put you on the stand. Yeah, but they're saying he is going to take the stand. And
that
there were
happen.
Rumors that he was not eating... the food while he was in jail, and there was conspiracies whether he wasn't eating because he thought someone was going to poison him, whether it's just because the food sucks.
White people food.
Or
no seasoning.
And some people were saying he might have been withdrawing. Going through withdrawal.
Okay.
It
could be all of those probably.
Because you know when they arrested him, he had drugs in his hotel room. What? Isn't that insane, that pink powder stuff that they were saying?
Like, I was going to say, if you arrested me right now, I'm covered in
drugs.
Not weed,
but like the pink powder stuff that he was using, it was like a mix of like ketamine and ecstasy and
Is that pink cocaine?
It could have been.
Pink cocaine is the shit that Instagram model was on when she just like T-boned some lady and killed everybody in the car. And yeah, that shit's like destroying people's lives.
And they said that he went to New York because they knew he was going to get arrested, so he like went there so it would be easier for them, so he didn't have to get extradited from Miami. But then why would you have fucking drugs in your hotel room, you idiot?
It's also
like, it
not
doesn't
cocaine.
Make any sense.
It is a artificial and man-made hallucinogen that just for some reason they call pink cocaine but it is not cocaine.
It was right. Ketamine and ecstasy.
In fact, in what I've read.
And like a bunch of other shit.
In what I've read, it's highly synthetic. And also, in this
sometimes
article.
They put rat poison.
They
like
even
they
made
split
a joke.
Like
they're like, it would be healthier for you to do cocaine. They're like in yeah. the article. They're like, this is not good stuff.
It seems like Diddy was doing the shit that I see horrible kings on Game of Thrones
Did
do.
You guys watch the movie Blink Twice?
No.
The Channing Tatum film.
I heard it's good, though.
It is great, and there are a lot of similarities of what Diddy is being accused of that was in this movie. It was directed by Zoe Kravitz. Mm. So right. people are saying that maybe this movie was kind of alluding to some of this shit.
So, like, you could make a parallel between, like, Rosebud. That was about, wasn't about Hearst? That movie? What was the movie where he dies, he drops a thing, he says Rosebud?
That's I have no idea what you're talking about.
Anyway, but
before
like,
my time,
yeah,
me
but,
and Sam
but,
are
Rosebud.
it's a very Citizen Kane. So
okay.
Citizen Kane.
No, but isn't that black and white?
It is, but you should know about it because it's historical. All right, it's in the Library of
it's
Congress.
It's legendary.
It's beyond legendary. But my point is that movie they say was loosely based on. And I want to. It was some superpower like Rockefeller, somebody super powerful, right?
Yeah.
So they just based the entire movie off of that guy.
Yeah.
And this sounds like very much like a very similar type of deal where you, it's not the real
and
guy.
And people are like, you know, Lenny, he partied with Diddy. I'm sure Zoe growing up
and it was
in
Hearst.
Hollywood has seen some shit. You know what I mean? So.
But it's also like Daniel. Remember back in the day, we'd make the joke. If you had ultimate power, you'd be levitating. You'd be causing tidal waves.
A trail of death in my way.
Yeah. And then it's like
I would be horrible.
So it's kind of like that, right? It was like in Game of Thrones, like when the king can do whatever he wants, he is treating people like shit.
Yeah.
Like
yeah.
he is having a bunch of basically human slaves around him, and he's like he's paying the guy to drink this wine until your belly. Explodes out, you know. It's like you know, you
I've
become crazed with power.
Yeah, that's what Game Show Drew did to us yesterday.
But it sounds like that's what happened to this guy, right? He became crazed with power, and then he starts doing all this horrible shit, and it finally caught up on him, which is crazy that people it didn't catch up to him like 5 years or 10. Why did now that it caught up to him?
I think it got kickstarted with Cassie's lawsuit.
Okay, so there was a. Catalyst.
Remember, she got paid out literally the next day.
Right. And once we saw that video, I kind of feel like there was an obligation of like
leaked.
Almost the world was like, well, we
can't deny that.
This person can't continue.
Because before it was just a bunch of other rappers and hip hop artists talking about wild parties and he might be gay
there
and he did
a
bad
lot,
shit.
There's been a lot of rumors about Diddy for years, but they're all alleged, right?
Yeah, but this video, it seems like once we had the video, it was like everybody globally was like, well, sorry.
There's some legitimacy here.
It was like we have to do something now because it's like, but it's not.
When Cassie started her lawsuit, I think she was already working with the feds to put this all together.
Yeah, but there's a different. Like, if you want to be, you could be as kinky as you want and have sex parties at your house.
Consensually,
all you want.
Yes.
Yeah, and then do like you could because that's what back in like 15 years ago. It's like, oh, P. Diddy has this tantric sex for 15 hours.
He talked about it openly. Yeah, in articles, he would talk about it.
And then you think to yourself, like, if I was as rich as him, like, I'd have these crazy parties with girls and tantric sex. But then, like, he turned into the fucking Joffrey.
Yeah.
And then he's like, I want to shoot your ass with a crossbow.
Yeah,
at the Davenport Millers?
He shot the hottest fucking girl on that show. And I had to look up that girl in Game of Thrones, and she was a porn star, the redhead.
And then you're like, you can't
that's
do
that. That's how
horny
I am.
You're a horrible monster. Like, and then that's where it's he just turned into a horrible monster.
To go back to what
he always was, and then the money just made it worse.
There's rumors that he learned it from Clive Davis, and that's how
which is weird.
Who's
that? It's weird that they put Clive.
He's an old school.
But he's an old white guy,
producer.
Right?
Yeah.
But the one there's the other one I heard that they really zeroed in.
Russell
on.
Simmons.
Not Russell. There's one more. I'm blanking on the guy's name because I kept asking ChatGPT because they did list Clive and I was like, well, that's weird because you don't really hear anything bad about
I've
that
heard
guy.
Some things about Whitney Houston's death.
Oh, really?
And, yeah.
I don't know.
Well,
it's
sure
not my world.
There's a lot of other performers that are nervous about what's going to serve.
Oh, sure. And not just in the music industry.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, rich people.
Yeah. The mayor of New York City literally got indicted yesterday.
Oh, really?
Yeah, and he gave Diddy the key to the city last year.
Well, that's some people, like, even they ever knew Puff Daddy.
Yeah, not everyone was at these white parties were
I don't believe that, but there are
you know, allegedly politicians and actors and everybody in Hollywood and, like, you know, famous people that are not just musicians. Allegedly on these tapes.
I think to my, like, what if I went to P. Diddy's party? Before he was accused of...
What if we dressed as manatees at P. Diddy's party?
Indie Polo.
Like, that'd be fucking awesome.
Let's say alternative world, me and Daniel's podcast, and then Sam, she's in this...
Oh, I stayed in this one because you guys were successful.
Yeah, that's right. I like this. And we're all rich and
we're so rich.
We're Rogan rich. Like, someone offered us...
Rogan rich. Oh, my God.
We're Red Rogan.
I'm so red.
I'm like, I'm going to... Ice bath crazy.
And then I'm like, hey, Puff Daddy invited us to one of his freak parties.
So it's 1998 because he's still Puff Daddy.
I'm like, there's going to be a lot of stars there. We'll mingle.
I'll dress like a penguin.
So then we go to the party. You're dressed like the penguin.
The penguin.
And then that was a dick.
He's an asshole.
Then they're doing live sex shows and stuff.
Yeah.
And then I'm like,
and I'm eating shrimp behind them, and I'm waving at you like they're. Guy's like pumping another dude, and I'm like, "Hey, this is a fucking nacho
raising
bar."
Raising the roof.
I'm like, "Oh my God, nacho bar!"
We're like, "This is weird."
I was like, "It stinks." I was like that one guy. He did wipe his ass good. I see a little bit of doo doo.
I would say,
kind of porn star doesn't wipe their ass?
Right.
It would be like, I guess this is what rich people do. Yeah. They fucking do these live.
You know
sex
what I was told in the book I read about it? The lady that went to these parties, they would, as soon as you walk in, this is what would happen. The minute you walk in, they bring a silver tray, you get a champagne, and then there's 10 lines of different pills.
Don't drink the champagne.
And you take the champagne and you take your pill of choice, and that's how you start the party.
They tell you what it is, like what do you want, any kind of pill buffet.
It's like a pill buffet, and then you choose, oh, I'm an ecstasy guy today, I'm a, you know, Vicodin man today.
When the pills are lined up and they're like, this one's ecstasy, I would ask the waitress, I'd be like, are you sure you remember?
Right.
Because it seems like,
dude, that's a downer, dude. That's a fucking downer. Hold on, let me get out my pill looker. I'm going to take a picture of this real quick and make sure I check. What's it say on the back? XJ411?
It's a line of pills.
Is it XJ411?
How often does she do this?
Drunky would have took all of them.
Pills in my mouth. Drunken buyer, he goes downtown.
No, but I don't know. I mean, how could she remember every pill?
It's her job.
No, you should know.
But is that their whole... Did she work full
time? She's a pill lady.
Oh, no, did she have...
Jeffrey was just roasting.
Excuse me, is this ecstasy locally sourced?
No, I don't care.
It's organic.
Is this farm to table? Pharmacy to table?
No, I don't care. I'm just saying.
You have zero fun.
Man,
take some fucking drugs.
No, I gotta make sure which pill this is.
Yeah, but
Diddy party. TC Van would have popped any pill.
No, at Diddy's front yard. You're standing in the foyer.
They got
of
the
Diddy's
60
house.
Foot bed looking up at the stars.
There's a girl with fake titties. Hanging out, and she's holding a silver tray with she hands you champagne, and there's 10 lines of pills, and you're like, let's walk through each one of them. Which one's the mildest?
What are the side effects on this one?
No. It's like hot ones. Let's start with the mild.
No, I just want to know I'm like, I want to take the ecstasy. And then she's like, this one? And then I'm like, well, they all kind
of
look the same.
And then you're like, well, this Mike McHorn. She's like, sir, inappropriate.
I don't want to take the Xanax if I think I'm taking ecstasy, and then I'm all tired.
Dick doesn't work. And then you get a floppy blowjob and then penguins. It stinks like penguins.
Well, soft noodles.
The lady is like, I'm sorry. I made a mistake.
Like,
I didn't know.
To blow you, and it's so floppy.
Like, this is my second day on the job. I don't know. Like, I need to know if she knows. That's not good. That's crazy. Anyway,
well, it's no fun.
Yeah. Let's continue.
You know? Right. Part of the fun is the spontaneity.
What else have we got, Sam?
We were talking about Channing Tatum because he's in that Blink Twice movie. He finally settled his divorce after 6 years.
Goddamn, why does it take so long?
I don't know. They're fighting over money. They're fighting over kids. They have one kid together.
I would do it that way. I'd draw it out.
Their kid is 11 years old.
I'll fucking torture Andrea.
So since 5 years old, this kid's been
dealing with...
I would
do all kinds of fucked up shit.
The lawyer gets all the money.
I'll send videos to Andrea of me fucking other girls. They'll
use that against you in the court of law.
I'll flush it down the toilet. Emotional people will just...
His ex-wife has had a baby.
In the time that they've been
the kid's in college by now.
Yeah.
Don't you want to finalize it and then just move on?
How fast can you get a divorce?
You can do it fast. If you just
write that down for Mo. If you all agree on everything, you can do it in like
write
a day.
That down for Mo. You know what would be fun? I'll get a divorce from Andrew. We'll see how fast we can get it done. We'll get remarried. But just to see, like, to really do it.
Yeah, there's paperwork involved, but you can do it.
And can so, you do it
you
as quickly as a medical marijuana
but
recommendation?
But then, joke's on you, Andrea won't marry you again.
I know. I've got a trap.
She's like, I did it. Yeah,
you're like, why are you running?
I tricked her.
I know. It's like Rumpelstiltskin. She tricks me to unmarry her, right?
Tom was in on it the whole time.
She ran so fast, her hat blew off.
That's how you and then Tom goes into business with Maisie.
That's how you know you're running fast, when you run your hat off.
Oh my God, that's old man trying to catch a bus. He's like, oh, and his fedora flies off.
Anyway, what else we got?
Have you guys seen JoJo? Are you familiar with JoJo Siwa?
I love JoJo Siwa. I love her crazy fucking
dance.
You know,
she's rebranding.
Yeah, she invented gay pop.
Mm-hmm. Every time and I hear makeup. JoJo Siwa, I think of the guy that sings I Think You're Crazy or whatever.
What?
The guy, he's got some thing with his hands. He
what are you talking about?
He's like a heavyset black guy. That CeeLo there.
Oh, CeeLo Green? Yeah.
You think CeeLo Green is JoJo Siwa?
Well, when you say JoJo
I
Siwa.
That guy.
When I launch my camera, he talks like that. He's got big old fat mega choppers.
He also sexually, allegedly like, sexually assaulted somebody.
Correct.
He did the whole
thing. Everybody does.
Everybody does. He did the whole season of The Voice with a fucking parrot on his shoulder. Do you remember that? He did a whole season of the show, The Voice.
And did it ever talk?
And that's the one where you turn around, and he'd be like this, and he'd hit the button to turn around, and he'd turn around, and he'd be a fucking parrot, and he'd be like, I remember when.
I pick you.
It was fucking awesome, dude.
So, JoJo Siwa is another.
She's the one that sold, like, all those big bows and stuff.
She was a Nickelodeon star.
It really pushed her hard.
Wasn't she a Nick star?
I think she was a Nick star.
Yeah, a Nickelodeon star.
It was beyond my time. I was
too
old
for
it.
She came out of the show Dance Moms.
Yes, she was a Dance Moms kid.
Okay. So, Maisie knows exactly who she is because my daughter has seen every episode of Dance Moms.
Is she a fan of JoJo?
No.
Okay.
No. Too babyish. It's baby butt. Yeah, she's like, that's for...
But the rebrand JoJo...
No, not Maisie, conservative Christian.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. She has family values now. Yeah.
I mean, she'll pray for JoJo's gay soul, but that's about as far as it
goes. She just did a photo shoot for the cover of Lady Gun magazine. I don't know if you want to pull this up, Dan.
What?
Where she is in a bedazzled corset that looks like a man's body with like a six pack out of bedazzles, diamonds, and then a cup with a full fake...
Weenie.
Peen.
I can't put that on. I can't put that on.
I don't think you can.
Well, I'll get
look
kicked
at
off Twitch
and
if
she's
I put
doing,
that on. It's a full...
She's like, doing the Lil' Kim squad.
It's a full weenie.
Okay, so she
I mean,
has,
I can put it up for us to see, but yeah. Like I'll get flagged 100% because there's nipples and a weenie.
So you know those one-piece bathing suits that the like wives buy
with
the husband face on?
Yeah, can we knock that the fuck off, please?
Yeah.
Can we stop that?
Every time I
it's
see
off-putting.
It.
Yeah,
unless you have one. I'm sorry. I have a habit of doing this, and there's guests in here, and I
want to tell the people, like, don't do that.
Shame them.
No one thinks it's funny.
Yeah. I mean, you know who did it?
I see it, I'm disgusted.
You know who did it?
God, you know who did it?
I'll call her out.
By everything.
I'll call her out. It was Jade, formerly of XL 106.7.
Oh, Radio Jade.
Now,
what's her name?
Radio Jade. Now on Apple Music. You can catch her every morning. Apple Music. She's way more successful than we are. She wears one, and you got to knock that shit off.
Yeah.
You're better than that, Jade.
You are better than
that. You're an attractive woman that works for Apple Music. You just got married. You got a beautiful kids. You knock that shit off.
So she has.
And Jelly Roll? Knock your shit off too.
Knock off.
She has that imprint, but of a full male body, including genitalia, on the.
It's pretty cool. It's cool.
Listen, it's pretty impressive. Whoever made that.
Yeah, it's cool.
But yeah, this is her doing her thing now.
I mean,
it's her rebrand.
I wish she'd gone a little less hyper gay, because I feel
I don't even know what. I feel like. My theory is she was so pushed into being everything feminine as a child through Dance Moms, wearing makeup so young and bedazzled things. And then she, even through the Nickelodeon thing, pink and bows and sparkly and da da da. So this is her, like, I don't know, trying to go ultra masculine. I don't know. I think she needs therapy.
I mean, if putting bows in Maisie's hair is going to make her wear bedazzled the dick
what her parents did to her was a little overboard. I mean, they branded. Do you remember all the JoJo Siwa stuff that was literally anything possible was branded JoJo Siwa.
There's something.
She was a brand. She's not a real person.
There's something off with her confidence. Like, I see it's fake. Like, she puts her face all over her Lamborghini,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, it's so cringe.
And it's like, you don't need, you're talented. And you know how to perform and sing, and you know how to dance. Everything that you're doing right now,
it's for attention, though.
But you don't need to do it. You have attention, and you have talent. So what you're doing is like harming what you have. It's hurting your reputation.
You don't need the marbles in your anus.
That's excellent. You know,
it feels very much like that.
Some do. You don't need that.
You can stand on your voice and your performance.
Yeah. I mean, you may get to a point where you need those marbles, but you're not there yet.
So, Sam brings up something that I have thought about, and I know it's not all like this, but now that I've seen someone that truly is driven by their own wants and desires, like Maisie, right? Like, she is like,
oh, she loves it. Yeah, it's not a forced thing at all. That's her thing.
I 100% will tell you. I see, you know, I've said this before. Daniel and Andrew don't force Maisie.
She'll
to
choose
do this
dance over me or Andrew.
I hear behind the scenes, you guys are like, God, she wants to do dance.
Oh, this morning you heard it. With Andrew, Maisie was like, I'm going to dance, and we're going to see the UCF game against Colorado.
Oh, cool.
And we're like, I got a ticket for it. She's like, I don't do that. I want to dance. I dance. Yeah. I don't do football. That's your dumb, stupid adult crap.
Yeah. So she
I don't do that.
And so maybe some of these child actors and actresses are like Maisie.
For sure.
And because I've always assumed it was the parents forcing them to do this.
Not all of them.
It was their parents' dream. And because I'd never seen in myself a kid that was that driven to do what she wanted.
You know what you
do.
Don't see? You don't see what I force her to do. Sing. Sing with daddy. Play guitar with daddy. Drums with daddy.
Yeah.
It does nothing. I do force her to do some things, but not dance.
Yeah.
That's her thing.
Yeah. And so
stuff I force her to do, she fucking hates.
Some of these child actresses or actors are like literally obsessed with becoming famous doing it. And then their parents, I don't blame them. They're like,
Demi Lovato just came out with a new documentary called Child Star, if you want to watch that.
Was it the opposite? Was it her parents?
It was a little bit of both.
Okay.
She enjoys it, but she was
more on she wanted to be a star, but like she had a family, kind of like, I don't know if you guys watched that whole Nick Carter and Aaron Carter documentary too, but
I did not.
You know, they kind of just had a mom that like didn't know anything about Hollywood and kind of got swept up with people taking advantage, and you know,
so it was,
but then also like letting other people essentially do what they want with your child and also not creating boundaries for your children, right? So then they're overworking your children, you're not standing up for your children, kind of thing.
Yeah. Especially in a different time, you know.
Absolutely.
Like child labor law.
20 years makes a difference. I never thought it did when I was younger.
It does.
And now I see the older people in my life, they were telling me like, oh, it was totally different when I grew up. And then I was like, it couldn't be that different. Yeah. I was like, oh, it is.
Yeah. I can hear you say that.
And then also, you're right, like people just take advantage of other people, especially in the entertainment industry.
Especially if they have a talent.
And especially people that are struggling and are desperate, right?
To be
famous.
You know, I was thinking of I've been thinking about this because, you know, May is unique in that she has found something very early on that she likes and she's self-motivated to do it. But we have a good friend, Detective Barb's son.
Golf.
He's upset. Oh, yeah. He's like maybe even more than Maisie is with dance. He is like a little, like, I don't even think she tells it. Like, he goes, gets home from school, gets his clubs, goes out back and just starts woodshedding his shots. Like, he's that guy.
Yeah. That's crazy.
It's crazy. Yeah. It is crazy.
But that's how champions are born. It's like, that is what it takes. Like, I didn't know that.
And I think he's been that way since like 3 years old. Like, he was doing it like as a baby.
Yeah.
Which is nuts.
I saw some kid running the other day. I told you, like, he was just running, like, practice running at 5:45 a.m.
Yeah.
And I'm like, God damn, you're 11 years old and you're like training.
Is he in track and field or something?
Probably. But he took it upon himself. Now, maybe his parents forced him to do it, but he's out there doing it. And
crazy.
I'm like, God damn.
Yeah.
What else I think you got over there?
Did you see the mom that got arrested at Disneyland this week?
No.
There was a bunch of different TikTok videos of this lady getting walked out by the cops with her hands behind her back. She had two small girls with her screaming for help in Spanish. It's a very heartbreaking video because, you know, the kids are screaming. They don't know what the hell's going on. They're getting traumatized.
Yeah.
And there was speculation on why this lady was getting arrested. And it turns out this lady was, this is the fourth time in 2 months she has tried to get her children into Disney for free. Now, Disney has a policy that if your children are 3 and under, they can get in for free. And it appears they kind of let it slide, and they finally were like, hey, no more. And I'm sure she caused a scene, because Disney is not, they said she was not cooperative with Disney security, so police had to be called.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
Then they're dragging her through the goddamn park.
Oh, God. You want to see this?
So
oh, man.
I have
look at this shit.
I have a little experience with this.
Oh,
explain.
God.
Look at that.
Did you get dragged out of Fun Spot?
Oh, my God. The kids are crying. It's sad. That's bad.
It doesn't.
The mom screaming, you're fucking hurting me. She's cussing in front of everybody else's children.
Well, that's just, yeah, don't cuss.
Well, that's what you have to do when they are pushing you out.
Of course.
You're hurting me. I hit my head on your door.
Like the Asian guy on the plane. Remember when he started crying and bleeding? Oh, God.
Now, so...
I don't think I've ever laughed harder than that video.
There was a time where Max turned 4, and then...
Why did you start speaking like a... he got...
There was a time.
Did you hear how Castleberry got? He's like, there's a time when Max, we were going to get... Like, why'd you get a redneck voice
on? So, I think, maybe it wasn't this bad. Maybe Tommy was like 4.5, and Max was like...
You're padding this.
Tell us the truth.
Yeah.
Like, almost 4. Anyway, they may both have been over the allotted age limit where
yes.
we'd have to buy.
Sure.
They couldn't get
him
free.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then me and Crystal said never to talk about this.
It's fine.
Is this so when you pretended
like,
to be?
I was like, they can't ride anything. They can't even do nothing.
Right.
So why are we paying child price? I got to pay $69 bucks.
Let's just pretend to be handicapped like we did last time with your mom.
No, I was just like,
Joey's friend got in trouble for that.
Yeah, Joey's friend got popped.
I was just like, you know, sit in the stroller. Or we'll push you away.
Yeah.
And if anybody talks to you, just go like,
hold up the number 2
open
when they
your
ask
mouth
you.
And just go like,
And then we'll
just
push
act
you
like you're about to say something.
And there was an employee. This happened at, I was about to say Animal Planet. It happened at Animal Kingdom.
How dare you kick me out of Animal Planet?
The lady that was like taking our tickets looked down and she said to Crystal,
he's smoking a cigar.
Looked at Crystal, and I was like, listen, if anybody says anything, we're gonna be like, we didn't know the rules. We will go back and buy the tickets.
That's a lie. You're a fucking liar.
I'm like,
that's a premeditated lie, dude.
Yeah.
And then Crystal,
if anybody asks, we're just gonna bold-faced lie to them.
And then Crystal's like, they're not allowed to ask. Is company policy?
No, it's not like
sovereign citizen.
Not allowed.
I know my rights.
It's not like medical
not
records.
Allowed
not allowed to ask. That's my private
HIPAA.
Medical records.
Yeah.
They can't
I got AIDS.
I'm like, are you sure? She's like, they're trained not to ask because Mr. Disney doesn't
How
want.
How dare you ask? My son has AIDS and all he wants to do is go to Disney.
And so we walked in and then we were pushing the kids and I'm standing there and I'm embarrassed as hell. And then
when are you embarrassed?
And then the lady looked at the boys and they're like, and the lady's like, are you sure they're under 3? She literally knew. And then I was like,
and
oh
that's
my
what I'm
God.
Saying. I think they did that to this lady. Again, this was her 4th time
doing
it.
Yeah, that's Castleberry Senorita. They shut down another Castleberry Senorita.
They did.
Oh, man.
Chris was like,
she went right back to her funnel cake store. She's like, sorry, I was going to take you guys to Disney, but we got to man the funnel cakes and the aqua frescas again.
Chris was like, yes, they are. And then the lady's like, mm-hmm. And then we just kept. And then that was
you
the last
that
time.
You know that lady
that was the last
took
time
pictures of... No, you can never go back.
Oh, we've never been back.
Oh, you're video flag. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Do you know when I was walking... do you remember that story of me walking into Disney?
With a knife.
And I had a knife, but I took it off my belt, and I put it in my pocket. I'm like, I got this. Man. And I started walking in, and this lady goes up to me. She goes, you're going to need to deposit your knife before you go inside. I'm like, how did you know I got a knife? She's like, I saw you put it in your pocket.
I walked into Disney Springs the other day. Maybe I shouldn't say this.
Okay. Yeah. Oh, what'd you do?
And, you know, I'm medically allowed to have the marijuana's bud docs, you know.
I had
my medicine on my person, and they have cops now there. You know, it's not just security. They have cops there with the drug dogs, and he walked like the dog didn't. The cop himself walked the dog to me. What would you do? Would you freak out?
I think those are bomb dogs.
I would tie Rick Hillen.
They're not drugs.
I'm like, get that dog out.
They profiled me as a bomber?
Well, I there is
okay. We
okay. Hold
okay,
on.
I'm gonna tell you the truth. Don't listen to him yet. Hold on. Listen to me first.
Okay.
He's gonna tell you that they're bomb dogs,
mm-hmm.
and I believe that as well. But we don't know that for sure.
Yeah, it's just that they're not allowed to ask. It's the right, they're not allowed
right?
to ask.
Am I right?
There's yeah. I was told it's not drug dogs.
There
yeah.
is a thing in the police dog world called sniff them titties.
Is that a thing?
You know what? I've never heard of that, but I would bet my daughter's life there's called something called sniff them titties.
Yeah, yeah.
And STT.
Because yeah. cops are horny as fuck.
There's this the same thing in the paramedic world. I know it yeah. for sure.
Firefighters, not as much. Not as much.
Firefighters will blow your titties. They'll blow your titties out with their hose.
Yeah.
Like, there is, like, a, you know, and it's not talked about because, no. You know, you're like, ooh, diddy.
Little diddy titty.
But if you have your dog wandering around, you know.
You give him the old sniffaroo.
Have him wander towards yeah. the hot girl.
And it does make you horny to see your dog's nose indent the titty. Just like,
and they're like, I'm sorry, my dog has to sniff around.
It might get a number, right? You might get it. Be like, oh, I'm sorry. Get out. Come on. Get over here. Laser. What are the dogs? They always have some aggressive name. Get over here, Tank.
Let's do one more.
This is kind of a throwaway, but there was a video, I think it was with E! News, that The Rock did an interview with, and this kind of ties back to what Tuttle's doing. They asked what party trick he has that he can do, and he says it depends on which kind of party.
If it's a ditty party.
Well, he said if it was a child's party, he would just, you know, bust out the Maui impression, you know, Maui from...
I see what's happening here.
But he said, he goes, but,
don't lower yourself to that.
Knock that shit off.
You're a goddamn billionaire.
But he said, if it was an adults only party, he has a grape trick that he does where he can pick up a grape without his hands, feet, or mouth.
Tuttle has that trick. Yeah. He'll be doing it later at the content house.
Well, Rock said this himself in an interview.
It's got to be with his butt cheeks. That's
what I would. Assume.
And that is not that much of a trick.
Anyone
right?
can do that. If you put a grape on the ground
that?
Right now, I can
right,
sit on a grape.
All right, that's the new TikTok channel.
Look, if you put a grape, if you put cool. anything on the ground right now,
let's
I can sit
Publix
on it and put
right.
it in my ass.
Let's go to Publix right now and get a grape.
That's not that hard.
Let's get a kernel of popcorn from the bodega.
I can do this. I can pick this up with my asshole.
Hold on, maybe it's harder than we think.
I think it's harder than you think.
Well, if it's my bare ass, because I'm very moist.
It has to be bare.
I'm like Spider-Man. I can pick up anything with my ass.
So we the Rock takes his whole pants off.
I don't know.
See what's happening here. What's going on? Excuse me, Maui's picking
what
up grapes.
What can I say except to welcome?
You know what would be really impressed me? If he picked up the dead grandma. The stingray. The stingray grandma.
Yeah. No, I feel like when does he do this?
It says right
he
here.
He said an adult party.
He said, if it's a party for kids, I could transform into Maui. They all start to gather around. I know it's a lot, the hair, the butt, when you're staring at a demigod. He's doing all
the songs. Yeah,
he's like, you're welcome. He says, I make my pecs bounce. The kids go crazy. It's awesome.
Which is kind of weird.
That is a little weird. The pecs
make
bouncing,
my pecs bounce for children?
I don't think...
The Rock, you need to stop talking.
The pec bouncing thing is... No one does it anymore.
Don't do that.
I do the dick wristwatch.
Wait, did Cadillac Pat not do that on the cruise?
I squeeze my balls and I'm like, look at these brains.
He was really sad.
Look at his brains.
Yeah, you squeeze your balls hard, and then all the veins pop to the top, and I go, Mega Mind!
The kids laugh. They're like,
good
can I touch
God.
It? I'm like, you can touch it.
He says,
don't cut this out.
That's not bad. I was just touching
the brain. Why did I come here? I shouldn't have brought this story up.
It's funny, not in real life. If you just didn't realize, like, oh shit, this is bad.
Out of context.
I'm like, I promise.
It's not bad.
This
if you're
is
doing,
innocent.
I was just doing it for
it's
fun.
It's
okay if you're dressed like Maui.
It's fine.
He says, if it were an adult party, he chuckles, with tequila, I do this thing where I can pick up a grape, not with my hands, not with my feet, not even my mouth. Right now, my publicist is like, please, God, don't say anymore. Don't, please. I pick it up with my penis.
Yeah, you have to tell us, because now we're thinking it's worse than it probably
is. Yeah, is it possible to do it with your foreskin? Is that
I couldn't do it. I got a loose, baggy foreskin.
Like, if I'm at a party.
I've got a Jose Baez foreskin.
Like, baggy brown?
Baggy brown, like Obama's baggy brown suit.
Like, say I went to Samantha's party. I go there.
Right. Never going to a party. I can guarantee.
You're no fun.
I'll bet my daughter.
I'm an after party.
I'm gonna give you the pill choice at my party.
I've been to an after party at Samantha's house. You know, the thing, the after party. You should record.
Oh, you sound so confident.
What the fuck? Why are we talking about this?
I've been to an after party. That's what it's called, right?
And so imagine.
It's at the woodshed.
And there's a bunch of people around, and everybody's doing some, you know, like, you know, just little
some
tricks.
Gentle butt fucking.
Everybody's doing little tricks.
No, no, so someone puts the quarters on their elbow and they grab them.
We're
fast.
Just all
is that a trick?
We're all standing around doing lame party tricks.
Tying cherry stems with our
tongues. What the fuck is the rock
I'm
talking
like
about?
Hold on, I'm doing it.
But imagine
I'm doing a party trick.
I can flip my eyes inside out.
Yeah. What's Travis doing? He's playing a strum in his guitar.
Yeah,
maybe
he's playing guitar.
He's singing with your dog. They're howling.
Yeah, they're howling together.
Well, what is the rock talk? He's saying that people do party tricks randomly
at
parties.
Well, he's a dumb old man. Nobody does that.
But imagine if I was like, hey, get a grape. Wait till you see what I can do. And you put a grape and I take my pants and underwear off.
Yeah.
Are you cupping? Yeah. You're cupping your balls. You'd have to.
Yeah, but you can see the size. And you see the hair.
This is Oprah's house in Hawaii.
And then everyone's like, please. And you're like, no, you gotta see this.
No, you gotta do that. I'm eating a chicken finger from Publix right now.
You're never gonna believe what he can do.
And then I go down and I pick a grape.
But you fall. And you fall. The first time you fall, you smash the grape with one of your cheeks.
And then I pick a grape up with my asshole.
Oh, 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 oh.
And then I'm like, look at this. And then you're like, Jesus Christ. You're gonna all talk shit after
he's
I
leave.
He's Maui. Oh, once you leave,
he's giving him the old Maui Wowie.
Leaves, I look at you, I'm like, what the fuck was that? This guy fucking showed his cock. He was putting grapes in his ass.
You all, so isn't that happening?
I would call the police.
Yeah, you would
I would call the police.
This guy's
I'd be
in
like,
Disney movies.
I'd be like, he just left my house, he put a grape in his ass, and it was inappropriate. He exposed himself to everyone.
He was bouncing his pecs.
Showing
me the brain.
To pull up my underwear, I have to take you two hands, and then you see my dick.
And then there's a grape in your pants now. Now there's a smushed grape in your fucking underwear.
Has he done this or not?
Sounds like he has.
He hasn't done this. He's a dumb old man. He's lying. He was lying to be cool. He's not cool. All he does is act and work out.
Did he think that was a cool
I'm
story?
Telling you, he's not cool.
Yeah.
He doesn't do anything fun.
Yeah. To look like he does, he just works out all the fucking, this is what Seth does.
And spend time with his family.
Morning and night, and then work. He's a workaholic.
Yeah, it's just like
he
Seth.
Does nothing else.
Have you seen, you know, Seth is dead now. Like, you'll never see Seth ever again. No, you'll see him at the gym working very hard.
Dude.
You'll see him running his karate dojo,
you know,
like a
works?
Master. And then you'll see him spending time with his family, and that's it. He does nothing else.
That's what happened to you guys.
Yeah.
You have no heart at the time.
It sucks.
It does. That's why I want Tuttle to become a legend.
Do it for Tom.
The rest of us are doing the standard, and it's not fun.
It's not.
Anyway. All right. Sam.
I guess I got to get
some
grapes.
The standard last night.
What do you mean?
Couldn't come.
No, come on.
Couldn't do it. Had to pretend like I did.
No,
I faked it. But I know when my wife sat on the toilet and nothing came out, I knew she was like, wait a minute, this is something's happening.
Come on.
So I even threw in an extra compliment. I was like, well, that was a good one. like to try and throw her off the scent.
Women shouldn't get so upset.
No, you know what I did? You know what I did?
They take it off like it's something for them.
It was so good. I put it in. Yeah. It was so good. And I was about to go fast. And I was like, stop. And I did that move.
You edged.
And I was like, and then I went out. And I'm like, I'm good now. And then I started going. I was like, oh, shit. I'll never get it back.
You lost it.
Yeah.
Never get it back.
You're too old to edge, man.
I am.
Yeah.
And you gotta just let it happen.
That's the name of the show.
Because
I am. That's a dangerous game.
That's a young man's game.
And then I had to ask her, and she knew, because this morning I was like, wow, I'm so horny all the time. And she's like, I know what this is about. She's like, we can do it tonight.
Oh, you get that? I get that. What the hell is wrong with you? Yeah. I was like, you're fine.
Are you fucking somebody else?
Yeah. Who are you thinking about?
Who are you thinking about?
Say me.
Well, that would be bad if you couldn't come.
Say me next time. Say Daniel.
All these medications.
Adderall.
Anyway, all right.
Andrea's in there. She's like, I'm not a dummy.
Oh, no.
She's not. I know she's not.
And don't you think we feel bad?
She'll tell me. She'll go, don't do that.
That means we're dying,
she'll
by
tell
the
me.
Way.
She's like, don't do that. She's like, don't do that. You won't be able to get it back. And I'm like, I can fucking get it back. I can always get it back.
She told you?
No, she
it's
has
emasculating.
Told me that.
Okay, okay. It means we're less of a man.
It does.
It does.
And then the last time I was like doing it, it was just like, it's going everywhere. It's like literally like a wacky inflatable flailing arm tube man.
Even that manatee finished in his dead body.
We cannot True. End on
yeah,
that.
Yeah, I think we can. That's the end.
Semantics.
Dino, come on.
Find it everywhere. Podcasts are heard.
Find it.
She does a Twitch show.
Put it in your ears.
Mm-hmm.
Get that. And then and throw some money to the Patreon.
Like and subscribe.
And then
support a super small business.
Yeah. And then tell them about some of the extra shows that you guys do for your Patreon.
Yeah, so we do the after party, like Tom said. You never know what kind of party tricks we're going to have on there. You can sign up for our patreon.com/semantics. Also, I do a series on Twitch called Sippin' with Sammy every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday around 9 a.m.
Yep.
And I am having another cruise. We're doing Semantics SC again next year. Yeah, we're going in October next year. So semanticssc.com for all the details
spooky
on
cruise.
That. Yeah.
Like a spooky.
Maybe I'll show up at a Speedo.
Hey, it's no kids.
Yeah.
Anything goes on those hammocks.
Get your grapes, buddy. I'll see you on board.
I'll see you on the Valiant Lady.
All right, guys. We will see you on Monday's BDM show.
Yeah, Sam, thanks for being here. That was awesome.
Thanks for having me.
Super fun. Guys, thank you so much for listening. Yeah, BDM show on Monday. Is there anything else we need to plug for people?
That's it.